Brave is on a mission to fix what it believes is a broken web. Ads are everywhere. They follow you from site to site to site, collecting personal information, tracking your browsing activity, cluttering up content, all the while slowing you down. The average person downloads more than 2,000 ads and trackers every day. Brave wants to change that. They believe your web browsing data shouldn't be collected without your permission, packaged into a profile, and sold to the highest bidder to be used for even more advertising. Instead, Brave believes it can make the web faster, more secure, and more private without intrusive ads. To accomplish this vision, Brave has built a new web browser for phones and computers, the Brave browser, and an Ethereum-based token called Basic Attention Token, or BAT. The Brave browser blocks ads and trackers that compromise your privacy. To help websites make up for lost revenue, Brave makes it possible to acquire BAT and give it directly to your favorite sites. Or you can enable Brave Rewards, which serves ads that don't collect or sell your data. When you opt into Brave Rewards, the sites you visit are paid in BAT, and you're rewarded too for paying attention to the ads. It's a win for everyone, except all those third-party ad trackers, of course. Learn more at brave.com.
The Drunken Peasants Podcast.
I got to get a weird thing.
No! Say, man, you got a joint? No, not on you, man. It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
From the strangest corners of the internet, here to bring you opinions of the world from an altered perspective. Here are your hosts, the Drunken Peasants.
Oh, hello, everybody. Welcome to the Drunken Peasants Podcast, episode 557. And joining us today, we have three of the guys from EFAP. We were just on their show. What was that? Last week.
I think it was
week.
Sunday.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
My day's blurred together.
Wolf and Rags, welcome, guys.
Yeah, boy.
Hello. Hello.
Woohoo.
How do you do?
Doing pretty well. So, Billy, you made our show look terrible on the stream. I don't know. I read the comments, and everyone attributes me having poor taste in movies because of your poor taste.
Sounds
in
like
movies.
You must have really fucked up. If you could,
what?
They can blame,
I fucked up by asking you to be on their show.
Well, let's be honest. I was simply defending Captain Marvel, and as it turns out, Endgame revealed that Captain Marvel was busy with other planets already 2 days after the argument happened. Captain Marvel was busy with other planets who didn't have people like the Avengers at them.
Hey, the question wasn't why didn't she turn up, it was why didn't he call?
Maybe he did call.
Maybe he did, yeah.
The question was why didn't she turn up? But they answered that 2 days afterwards, I'm a feminist, right? So I had to defend it either way. Me and my friend Onision were feminists.
Fuck off.
I saw a girl once.
Yeah.
Same.
I'm a feminist.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're going to do things a little different because we have these guys on. We're going to cover one quick thing that we just had to talk about involving the Vigilant Christian Mario.
The Vigilant Christian.
I don't know if you guys are familiar with him, but we had to talk about...
That's a throwback.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we're going to have to talk about it because this video, wow. It's
Is it the one where he cries as he's telling everyone that he's leaving?
Again? Well, yeah, but there's been many of those. Yeah, yeah, there's been many of those.
He does that quite a bit.
Yeah, yeah.
I've heard that name.
This is the this one just takes it to a whole new level. He, wow.
The Vigilant Christian looks like Bill O'Reilly.
I don't think so.
This is actually Bill O'Reilly that we're looking at.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
What?
Yeah, this is actual Bill O'Reilly.
To be fair, Bill O'Reilly is a Vigilant Christian.
Yeah. He is.
Is he a Christian?
I'm sure he says he is.
Ties goes in, ties goes out. You can't explain
that. I mean, he says he is.
Yep.
I have no
reason to disbelieve him.
He also said he wanted to be sincere. He also said he wanted to rub a girl's body with a falafel because he didn't.
That was in the Bible. So
that was in the Bible.
Wait, what?
Well, he said he wanted to rub her body with a falafel because he didn't know the word for loofah. He was trying to be sexual to her.
He was sexting some woman, and he called it a falafel.
Because he didn't know what a loofah was. So that's the best.
After we play the Vigilant Christians video, then what I decided to do, because we have these guys here, is I pulled up some of the cringiest movie trailers of superhero movies, comic book-related movies from, like, you know, mostly the 70s, 80s, and 90s. I don't know how many of these you guys have seen.
The Golden Age.
Oh, yeah. Like the 1970s Spider-Man, that kind of stuff. It's pretty amazing.
I didn't even know there was a 1970s Spider-Man.
Oh, just wait. You wish you had remained ignorant to that fact.
Falafel Man.
Oh, yay.
Yeah. Yep.
Can't wait.
Yep.
Is it the Japanese Spider-Man or is it something different?
No, okay. It was an American production.
Because there was like a Japanese Spider-Man too. And then there was the Italian Spider-Man.
We'll get to it. You'll see. But first we have to jump into this.
Ooh. Oh, Gale Cord Schuler?
Man looking for man? Versus G, battle for supremacy.
All right, so here's...
Is that Dusty Smith?
No, that's Brett Keane. That's actually Brett Keane. That's the... Wow, that's hilarious.
Dusty has aged as badly as Brett Keane.
Could you tell Dusty he's
about the same age? Those two are about the same age.
You've seen him? He's like, what? How old is Dusty? Like 30?
No. Dusty's like...
Well, Brett Keane's also like 35, 36, right?
Oh, no. Brett's like 40, 41. Dusty's probably like 42, 43. So they're like in the same age range.
They both look like they're in their 80s. Sure, I'll give you that. I would rather look like Dusty than Brett Keane.
So
Brett Keane's basically just fat Dusty.
The Vigilant Christian was extremely popular among Christian conspiracy theorists on YouTube, and he got like 500,000 subscribers on his channel. He was getting millions of views. He was basically like almost like Mark Dice with a more Christian kind of twist to things that he did. And I mean, he made some videos admitting things he probably should have never have admitted. Like, he had trouble smoking weed too much, and he admitted that he got herpes. You know, just... And he would cry.
The weed gave me herpes.
Yeah. Yeah,
and I got the herpes weed.
He would cry all the time. People would always speculate that he was probably gay. He would always deny that. Well, he got outed. He was sexting with a catfish, I think. Someone catfished him into, like, sexting with them. And he ended up sending nudes of his friends. He was trying to get, like, gangbangs going with him and his buddies. He was trying to, like, recruit women to do this stuff.
For his godly bros.
It wasn't just him and his buddies. It was...
Yeah. He was sending nudes of his buddies to people. I don't...
I have a theory that the girl was just there to be a Trinity condom to keep him from being fully gay so that they could use her to keep their dicks... non-gay by having them inside of women while they had sex together.
Yeah, so multiple times this year so far, he's made a confession video where he claims to confess everything, and then he cries a bunch, and then he says he's gone. But now, you know what? I think this is it, and I kind of feel bad for him.
Oh,
but the reason I feel bad for him is because. He feels ashamed of a lot of things that he's done when really they're victimless crimes in many ways.
The gangbangs?
Well, I mean, if everyone's consenting. Well, he admits to all kinds of stuff.
The crime isn't the victimless part. Brother Mario, it's that he perpetuates a Christian fucking ideal at all costs to the point where he's promoting these conspiracy theories with a Christian name, and he doesn't live by it at all. Dang. He's a fucking hypocrite piece of shit.
I know many of you are going to comment and say, Mario, you keep saying it's going to be your last video. I promise this will be my last video. In this one, I'm going to
get... This is my last video, part five, basically.
...about my full confession before I go to rehab.
I wonder what his shirt says.
Now, I had to pray for a lot of courage to make this video. It's not going to be an easy one for me. I'm going to try and keep it together, but I'm about to confess.
I like how he wrote it on like a binder and just ripped it out.
shameful, disgusting things about myself, but I need to do this so that I can get better.
I wear Crocs with socks.
All sorts of people are on the internet now exposing me. And by the way, thank you guys. I just want to let you know.
He's thanking the people.
Is he thanking people for exposing him?
Yes.
Is he thanking us? Didn't we help?
No, we didn't expose him.
We tried, though.
No, I didn't try. What the fuck are you talking about?
Can the FAP guys tell Dustin?
My God, did he delete his channel?
He's a beautiful bird.
What was your question?
Did he delete his original channel? Because I looked him up, and he's only got like 51,000 subs on some vigilant vlog.
He gave his channel away to a guy who is like a Christian, vigilant Christian.
He may have sold it or something, but yeah, his big channel has changed. It's
like Warriors for Christ or something.
Yep, yeah. Oh, and by the way, we just got a donation, and they want to know if you guys will tell Dusty the Cockatiel that he's a beautiful bird.
You're a beautiful bird.
We get that every time.
God has used you to help me get the help that I need in my life. I love even people who position themselves as my enemies.
I want to thank
Jesus
and the drunken peasants.
Yeah.
And I just want you to know I completely forgive you, and God worked all this out for my good.
You.
I'm going to get the help and treatment I need.
I forgive you for the things that I did bad.
Well, right. He said, thank you, and I forgive you?
Right.
What do we have to be forgiven for exactly?
If he appreciates it, yeah, that's weird.
Yeah, that's because it's like a passive aggressive thank you.
it's just a general forgiveness for any sins.
Thanks, guys. Yeah, you're forgiven. Don't worry.
He used many of you guys to do that.
God used us.
You know,
God used us to expose him.
Damn,
guys, you're a little
Jesus came into my heart.
Vicious in the way that you make videos about me, so I figured, hey, I'm just going to expose myself here and lay it all out.
You can't expose yourself after you've already been exposed.
I'll show them.
Oh, he's about to take it to a whole new level.
Oh, he's got ears.
Pretty sure Jared exposed him at some point before he lost his mind.
Oh my God, no! Jared was a big fan of Mario, and Jared used to get mad at us for making fun of Mario. Oh yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that's crazy.
Was Jared
I thought he hated him, but then again, Jared's kind of an enigma.
No, if you search Jared and the Vigilant Christian, he made about two or three videos talking about how much he liked Mario.
You think Jared was trying to horn in on the Godly Bros gangbangs?
And Jared got mad at me before he blocked me from his chat because I was like, Vigilant Christian was in some gangbangs, Jared. he was getting all mad. And
that's ungodly behavior.
As you guys probably know, if you watch my recent video, I'm on a waiting list to go to a Christian rehab here in the capital in Ottawa, Canada.
Oh, God, that's not
going to
work at all.
Christian rehab.
Oh, could you imagine a Christian rehab?
I mean, there's, like, documentaries of that
shit. That's the problem.
People, like, sending their kids to, like, gay therapy camps, and they, like, abuse them and lock them in, like, sheds and shit.
He's going to rehab for drug addiction, too, and the thing is that God isn't going to cure his drug habit. That's something he actually has to do. So if he believes it's going to be magically done by God, then he'll never get clean like he wants to be. So, I don't know.
Bong hits for Jesus.
Yeah.
I placed myself on there because of crippling addiction. I can't overcome this, and I've just recently come out of denial. I had many years where, you know, when I first got saved, I got sober for like 8 months, and I thought I was good. I'm no longer an addict. And then I fell back into it for a month or two, and I wouldn't make videos or anything. I don't know if you guys remember. I would always disappear for a couple weeks or a month or so. Well, that's why. So I would relapse. I would fall into it, and I'd be like, what's going on? How did I get into this? And try to get out, pray to God, and I would get out. You know, God, by his grace, would allow me to recover and get sober again.
He would allow him out and then allow him back.
Yeah, by his grace, he led me back to the devil's lettuce.
Yep.
And so then I would have
thanks,
several
Jesus. You really helped me out.
More months where I had this mindset, well, I'm not an addict. I've overcome this. And then I'd fall back into it. And then I'd overcome it. And then that time I overcome it. I'm like, this has to be the last time. I'm for sure healed this time. And so I would just continue. But this has been going on and on.
When he comes out of it, it's Jesus. But when he goes back into it, it's the devil. That's how
imagine
it works.
Unironically claiming, I'm for sure healed this time.
Yeah. Well, this is for sure his last video ever this time,
yeah,
too,
we'll
right?
See. We'll see.
And it doesn't stop.
He does admit some shit that I'm like, wow, I can't believe he... Oh, here we go. Here we go.
Yes! Here we go.
He's here. Already crying. So recently I've admit that I need help.
That's quick.
I'm an addict. What a quick shift. I need rehab.
Yeah.
Oh, man, he's definitely bipolar. Wow. And he made a video a long time ago where he was like, guess what, guys? God healed me. I don't have to take my medication anymore. He was on some kind of psychiatric medication of some sort.
Yeah, I remember back, it must have been like a couple years ago.
Yeah.
Because I used to watch DP a lot all the time. And there was this one where he was wearing like some blanket and he was holding like a fly swatter or something.
Yeah, the Vigilant Pharisee.
Yeah,
that's what that was.
That was nuts.
How does this pills thing work? Like, does he think God is sending the pills? Like, I'm surprised he doesn't have the whole, you know, like, oh, I can't fuck with my mental state because that's against, I don't know, something. I guess he's cool with it. Fine. Yeah. What if Satan is in the pills? What about that?
Well, he's so fucking weird with God. At one point, he blamed God for his insurance claim not coming through. he almost left Christianity until the claim did come through like a couple weeks later. And he was like, I knew God would come through and give me my insurance claim on my new car. He's just a wishy-washy fucking weirdo.
I'm going to speed it up a little bit.
All right, come on, Mario.
Lightning speed tears.
I just want to also touch on the point that one of the reasons I think I'm struggling so hard with drug and sexual addictions is because of, in my past, I used drugs spiritually. You know, a lot of people use them recreationally.
Yeah,
spiritual drugs.
Yeah, like...
I use them that way, too.
I went on my vision quest to become a man.
Yeah, and he believes if you do that, you let demons inside more easily.
I actually used to use them in a New Age practice like a shaman, so I opened myself up with drug use.
Oh,
I opened up doors and things that shouldn't be opened up, and in sex...
Mario started. Shaman.
That sounded like possibly a reference to gay sex.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
I opened up doors that shouldn't be opened.
Yeah.
On to Tantra, which is sex yoga, and again, that is opening yourself up spiritually to so many things. And I think that the wound in my heart, which I'll discuss, is the root of my addiction. Plus,
yeah, tantric sex.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There is tantric yoga is like sexual yoga.
Teach us, Mario.
But tantric yoga, you don't come.
Yeah.
So he doesn't even spill his seed.
Yeah, you're like edging the whole time.
It's more Christian because you don't spill your seed needlessly.
Doors and the traumas that I've had in my life.
Pocket the seeds and put it in a lab so you never really wasted it.
Or you could Christian it.
Yeah, Christian. You can recycle it.
Under my hand, Mario.
Well, how does a Christian deal with that argument? Because you'd be like, no, save it for later. It's okay.
I just prevented a genocide.
Got a pocket full of jizzicide.
He looks like discount Jeremy.
So do you reckon this is genuine? Because it feels like it's...
Oh, it's genuine. He's like, gotta pump bipolar. Him, gotta pump him. It's because he's so bipolar.
So in those times of relapse, sometimes I would get cocaine, and this use got worse and worse to the point that it is now.
Damn, son.
So coke... oh, man. He talks about coke and hookers.
He talks fast enough. Should we really be speeding this up?
And here's the thing. Like, I'm okay with people doing whatever they want to do. So sure. I don't have a moral issue with him doing coke and having hookers.
I think there's someone you forgot to ask.
Oh, Jesus.
Jesus. About your cocaine and sex yoga binges.
The moral.
I love the idea that Mario's been healed and then Jesus is going to be like, I'm going to take the healing away. Just see what happens. See if he cries again. Just
right.
Fuck with
I just him. Yeah. Satan in like an overcoat. Like, you sure you don't want some more coke? Eh?
Like, oh, Satan, I know Jesus saved you, but...
Yeah.
Have coke.
No. It's not a daily habit, but when I binge, I can binge for a little while. And,
binge for a little while. Well, yeah, it's...
Isn't that the binge is, right?
Yeah, it's sort of the...
It's a problem, and I need help.
Aww.
All right.
Look at those tears.
Gotta put our serious faces on.
Yeah.
Do you want to hug him, Billy?
I want to.
I've been
those
living a double
tears.
Life as a hypocrite.
As a hypocrite.
Hypocrite.
My Hippocratic oath.
Yeah, he admits to making about $500,000 through YouTube and then spending it on hookers and blow, basically.
Oh, savage.
Wow, he's living this is not- life.
Yeah, and he's crying about it.
I remember that time when he was going to Walgreens to buy this binder.
I remember that time when he was like sobbing, trying to convince people that he wasn't doing YouTube just for the money.
I remember drawing like Illuminati shit out of Miley Cyrus music video.
Oh yeah, everything. Whatever the topical pop culture news story was, he made a video about how it was satanic. Whatever it was.
And that's the moral issue here, is that he was preaching one thing and doing another and emotionally manipulating people with lies on the trending fucking topics. That's the moral issue. I don't care if it's fucking
just
hookers
like,
and buying coke.
Jim Baker back in the day.
And, oh, yeah.
All those evangelists that got caught with hookers and drugs and all that stuff. Absolutely.
It's a running reoccurrence.
Yep.
You'd think maybe there is no true Christian except G-Man.
I'm curious if it's worse if you're like an evangelist type. Is it worse to get caught with hookers or drugs?
I would say hookers probably.
But most
because
of them get
a
caught
lot
with
of the,
boys
because,
anyways.
Because like that kind of stuff is actually in the Bible, but drugs not so much. Not specifically, because a lot of drugs we have now didn't even exist.
Except that
in biblical times. But
they were snorting frankincense back then.
They were snorting frankincense? Yeah. That'd be
I
really bad.
Frankincense for the baby.
Hey guys.
Incredibly irresponsible, sir.
Mainline
young.
Man, the fucking wise man that brought the gold was just showing off.
I brought gold. What'd you guys bring?
We had $320
limit, Balthazar. Yeah. But now we look like dicks.
It's just like, why did you guys ask me before we left? Like, why did you leave it up to now?
Not who I want to be in my heart. But because I did not get my addiction treated, these things started to continue to get worse and worse.
This guy,
left eye.
Yeah, he doesn't even wipe the tears away. Man, he cries in about, I would say he cries in about 60% of his videos. More than
life.
Just
fighting content.
Masculinity for Jesus.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess we don't have to watch this whole thing, but
I want to see him talk about the hookers and blow.
Okay.
We would do things, and I shouldn't, but I'll describe to you all the things we did in graphic detail.
That would be so good.
That the reason I'm an addict is because of a wound in my heart. I'll discuss that more, I'm
That's
sure,
also right, the
back
drugs.
And share with you my recovery testimony.
It's also the reason why you're a Christian, you fucking weirdo.
There's
you're trying to fill that
wound
with everything, drugs, God, and sex.
How dare you? This man is not a weirdo.
Seeking to self-medicate
totally
myself.
Normal.
And
normal
so, boy. Instead of going to God to heal and mend that wound, that deep inner wound that comes from my childhood.
For the 12th time.
I'm going to substances, to sex, to women to give me gratification, to give me... I'm going to things... To get what only
really
God
quick.
Can give me. And
did you notice how he had to separate?
I'm going to think the only God can give me.
He had to separate
I guess
sex and women.
Out.
No, yeah. That's why he had to get hookers.
He separated sex and women because the sex he was talking about, he's outing himself, wasn't woman sex. It was gay sex.
When I saw that Thai hooker for the first time.
You know what? At the end, because people have joked out on him for being gay forever.
Yeah.
He's never admitted it, but at the end of this video, he does admit to have had gay thoughts on occasion. He
says, gay fucking
he said he's never acted on it, but he has had thoughts, and God has to help him fight those thoughts too. That's what he said.
Just
maybe that's what
thoughts,
it is.
Buddy.
Maybe it is repressed homosexuality.
Maybe, of course it is.
It could be.
Of course it is.
I'm tired of it. I don't know why I do it. I'm stupid. I know there's no fulfillment
I'm stupid
in those
like a
things,
gay.
But yet I'm like a stupid dog going to eat its vomit. I go
no!
back.
That is the best.
What did he say?
A stupid dog going to eat its vomit. A stupid.
All I was doing was thinking about getting cum straight from the tap.
Yeah.
Somebody needs to do a hi, Billy, and cut that stupid dog that eats his vomit and then cut it into puking dog.
Yep.
That's the one right there. That was fucking money.
You cut, that was a whole page?
Yes.
I'm picturing like stick man.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is not even words, it's just doodle.
Yeah. A dog eating its vomit. Yep.
He has like a stick figure with circles for breasts.
So, because the wound wasn't healed in my heart, imagine you cut yourself. It gets infected. That's what my wound has been getting. So my addictions, imagine every time I've been relapsing, they're getting worse. You need
this analogy to explain it.
Without the analogy, I wouldn't be able to grasp the concept of being wounded.
It's like when you cut yourself. That's like, you know, when you're wounded.
Factor that made things really, really bad.
Have you guys ever been hurt ever in any way before? Well, for those of you who haven't, it's like this.
Explain it twice.
YouTube money. I made $500,000 in 5 years off my YouTube channel.
Nice. What did you do with that, buddy?
Yeah, good job.
And that money.
Truly were blessed by
because
Jesus.
I was an addict. Because I was not treated. Some of it got used. Oh, so a lot beautiful. Of it got used for shit.
For shit.
I don't have anything to show for it today. I owe the government and I'm going bankrupt.
Going bankrupt.
Bankrupt.
I am enjoying this.
You are enjoying I feel bad for him.
You really feel bad.
His notepad.
Here's why I don't feel bad, because he could just pray to God and get it all back, right? Right?
No.
You just pray to God. That's how it works, right?
God says yes.
He said he owes taxes.
Oh, so? He can pray to God to pay the fucking taxes, can't he? This little fucker used... He got all that money by manipulating Christians into fucking watching his videos and giving them their attention.
I mean, it's not totally his fault that Christians are so fucking gullible.
Well, he fucking made his money that way off gullible fucking Christians so he can lose it all in the same breath. Fuck him. I love this.
He's laughing.
I've never made money like that. I never did. I was making $15,000 to $17,000 a month sometimes. I had money now to fuel addictions that I never had before.
Yeah, this is an odd apology when you're flexing.
Right.
And I was living
I had to because I was so awesome, you know?
Yeah.
$15,000 a month, poor me.
And living a double life. And hating myself all the while.
All the while. Oh, baby. Come on.
Back to the first page.
Yeah. He went to look at those stick figure titties again. Little sex addict.
Two pages and he's getting lost.
So my sex addiction also continued to get worse because it was left untreated. As any untreated disease or illness or wound will. And
wounds heal themselves.
What is a wound? Men, animals, inanimate objects, tires, doorknobs. I do it all.
Wounds heal themselves.
You know, part of my wound is that I'm seeking. I need to.
Strange giggle.
Yeah.
He was just thinking of all the good times doing coke.
Yeah.
It's like, maybe I should do it again.
Dad, I love you. I don't know if you're watching this. I hope.
Yeah, this is where he blames his dad.
Dad, I love you.
He blames his dad here.
It's gone on YouTube.
But he loves him.
Blame you for this at all. I know your mom hurt you.
His dad molested him. Is that what
he's
saying?
I love how you jump straight to that.
I'm not, dude.
What, has he even said anything yet about that?
Oh my god! You know how humans work.
No, I know how your brain works.
No, because I know how humans work. That's why my brain works.
No, you don't.
Come on.
But you hurt me in a way
that
I never felt good enough, and I've always been seeking validation.
In the form of hookers and coke, because you weren't good enough, you dumbass.
And so, in high school, we didn't have, like, I'm 33, so back when I was in high school, we still had the non-smartphones. I don't know if you guys remember the Nokias, but...
Nokias?
Yeah.
Nokia, Motorola brick cellular phone.
Oh, that could just be a... In Britain, we call them Nokias.
Oh, okay. I called them Nokia.
Nokia.
Yeah.
There was no such thing as sexting, but that came later, and Once I started to get into that, I started to receive this validation coming back from the photos.
Oh, God, here he goes again.
Now I'm sad.
This is gross, and there's a lot of shame. I'm going to try and get through this.
Yes, spill it.
Therapy. Like, I don't know if you can tell, I'm broken to the end here.
Spill it.
This stuff breaks you. So don't get caught up in this garbage.
You didn't have to make this video. You could have just went to your fucking rehab and not told anybody.
But he did it for us.
Yeah, whatever.
He did it for drunken peasants.
For the monetization.
Yeah.
Run, kids, run. Run from this, because this is what happens. Just emptiness and brokenness and being lost.
So I would start receiving validation from the messages, and this would temporarily fill that void in my heart.
In my hair.
Oh, okay, this is not going to be easy.
Spill it.
I've also been a love and relationship addict. I don't know if you guys understand what that is, but basically, because there's a wound in my heart, because I'm not healed, I'm seeking through a relationship.
He attributes all of his issues to not having God instead of mental illness or just lack of discipline.
He's always had God, right? And
he hasn't, though.
But he's always had that option. The problem, he
believed that he does. And if you have a sincere belief that you have something that's kind of amorphous and ambiguous inside of you that's conceptual, and then you feel like you've... Like, it's basically like imaginary friend plus.
Yeah.
And so when all of a sudden you feel that it's gone, perhaps you just you don't take it well.
Right. Yeah.
You turn to blow.
Love, sex, to give me a sense of validation, comfort, intimacy that only God can provide. Good. And,
it does sound like he wants to fuck God.
My sex addictions got worse and worse and progressed continuously worse.
What you need is some personal responsibility, Mario.
I was searching for a truth that only a lie could give me.
Yeah.
You know, that's great. Beautiful. That's beautiful.
Fact.
Well, it wasn't like with me or anything like that. It's when I realized I wasn't with God, nothing was actually different. I instead of being okay with that, he's like, oh, God.
Yeah.
It's like going through all this fucking turmoil, and at one point you're like, maybe God's not real. And he's like, what? No.
Yeah. No, everything's changed. Man.
Okay. Here it is.
Here it is.
I've called escorts.
You called them what? Oh, dirty names.
Oh, poor baby. Poor baby.
Help this man.
I called them on the telephone.
Mario.
When he goes, I called the escorts.
And Mario telling Ruff the crime dog that he's a stupid dog.
Yes, I'll ask Mario.
Sexting and camming. Oh man, okay.
Here we go.
Here it is. I've called escorts. I've gotten so lonely and needed companionship so bad. I've called an escort.
Why didn't you just go to a bar or something? You're not a bad looking guy. Just go meet some lady.
Meet up with Rags. Maybe.
I always feel like his confessions are half confessions.
I'll make you scream God's name a few times.
Damn.
Yep. Make a man out of him.
He's only ever half confessing. These escorts were male escorts or trans escorts at best. They weren't.
I paid them in solid blocks of cocaine.
Let's see.
News and who knows where it's going to end.
Is he praying right now?
Sent inappropriate photos to women on Instagram.
Yeah, your friend's dicks.
That kind of pales in comparison to the escort and cocaine thing, though.
Yeah.
I'm just a piece of shit.
I sent nudies.
Wait, did you just say he's a piece of shit?
Yeah.
Wow, it's the first accurate thing he's ever said.
Who did get saved by grace in January of 2010.
Oh, thank you,
but
Grace.
Did not truly submit and yield to the Lord until this weekend.
this weekend.
It took him 9 years.
Until this weekend.
After making $500,000 on YouTube telling other people how to be good Christians, it was only till this weekend that he was one himself.
Right.
Good boy.
I should have watched my own video.
Because I had not come to terms with the fact that I was an addict and that I needed help.
Does he still consider his work accurate?
All right.
As a whole.
Actually, I feel a little
honor
better.
Honor and what?
It's all out there. There it is.
Good you for know, like you,
all
Mario.
Of his exposure and Illuminati, all that bullshit. Does he still stand by those
if
videos?
If you want to unsubscribe and unfollow me and hate me, and you have all the right.
This doesn't seem sincere, by the way.
Yeah.
I'm sorry for all of you who sent me money and I spent it on Phil. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
Thanks for all the cocaine and hooker money.
Yeah.
Now,
to be fair, YouTube got 30% of it, so whatever.
Don't sound so bad.
Yeah, which
so
is
maybe
worse.
YouTube got themselves some the cocaine and hookers.
Yeah,
and
their
I'd rather the money go to whores in Colombia.
30%.
Now,
please forgive me, everyone. Please forgive me.
I forgive you, Mario.
I forgive you.
I forgive him too. Well, there's nothing to forgive, really.
I'm
there
a
is.
Broken sinner at the feet of the cross, weeping for mercy. If you want to kick me when I'm down,
if you want to kick me when I'm down, I see it's.
Go ahead.
It's not really an apology.
He's not taking any personal responsibility for any of this, and that's why we kick him when he's down.
Full confession.
No, not full confession. Now tell people how you have gay thoughts. Gay thoughts.
I'm going to get some.
Talk about the gay thoughts
from Christians.
Let's hear about the gay thoughts.
I mean, this won't be the last video from him.
Probably not.
All of this, and I'm going to come out a new man. One of the guys. That
come in
goes to
man.
The program yeah, hey. To the conference this weekend, and he's graduating in 10 days, and he told me, Mario, I'm in person, and it gave me hope. I see all these guys in that home, and they're being made new, and I'm excited. This is gross. This is sick. This isn't me.
This isn't me.
If you're stuck being who deep down you know you're not, please seek God and get help.
Get help.
Keep right. me in prayer, Faith fam. I love you, and I'm
after
so sorry
all, it worked
for letting
me.
You all know.
Oh, did you skip the part?
There's a speaker there that spoke.
I'm trying to find the...
I'll take your word for it.
To surrender to you. Moving forward. But that is where my heart's intent is, and I'm on my... I'm very excited to go to Jericho. It's... And I think now through this, God is finally going to tear down my... To get them to fall in Jesus' name.
If we can't find him...
I'm
going to
come back and tell all you addicts...
You know, the
there
script
no
makes the apology great. Seem less sincere.
Yeah.
A little bit.
The two-page script.
If you just showed us my, that it was the doodle.
I need, fine. You know, it's either, there's two options. I die, this stuff's going to kill me,
or it doesn't kill you. Yes, those are the only options. Yes, it's a binary problem. Either it does or does not kill you.
I sent out, I don't even remember.
Mate, you could be in purgatory.
Come on, full confession.
All right, here we go.
What haven't I confessed?
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay.
You know, one thing that was happening too is I was getting hypersexuality induced by drugs and alcohol. If you don't know what that means, hypersexuality.
Yeah,
he's gonna.
Is when you're considering sexual things that you normally wouldn't.
Hmm.
And when I would drink and get drunk and do cocaine, smoke weed.
When your inhibitions were at their lowest.
Yes.
That's what would happen. And
trannies, animals, Mexicans.
Donkeys.
Yes, I've had homosexual thoughts.
There it is.
Yes!
There it is. There it is. One more time.
Yes!
Considering sexual things that you normally wouldn't. And when I would drink and get drunk and
I like how he got all quiet when he says
do cocaine, smoke weed. That's what would happen. And
here it is.
Yes. I've had homosexual thoughts.
I've had homosexual thoughts.
I like this. Up when he said
he
it.
Treats the actual usage of cocaine on a
yeah.
seemingly less solemn pedestal than just having homosexual
yeah.
thoughts.
This is the
yeah.
peak bad. Everything else is pretty bad, but
it
this.
It all pales in comparison to just having the homo thoughts.
You know how drunk I've been and I didn't have any homo thoughts? I've been so drunk, and I didn't have any homo
You have
thoughts.
Those when you're sober.
I don't have homo thoughts.
Yeah, because you ain't got the devil in you, boy.
I wish I had homo thoughts. I do.
You're wearing a pink bandana.
Because I don't even have homo thoughts. I can wear any color bandana. That's the best part.
It's not pink. It's light red. Talked about.
It's light red. Get it right. But Mario, when his inhibitions are at their lowest, meaning that he is at his truest, most purest form, he thinks of fucking gay sex.
I like how he gave that build up. Like, he had to give that disclaimer about how he does have gay thoughts, but only when he's wasted.
Yeah.
I mean, there's probably people in his audience who will actually unsubscribe from hearing that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's weird that this is that's the top tier thing. The act, calling hookers, going out, having weird sex party orgy things, doing cocaine and hard drugs, like the actual Mexican action of doing that stuff pales in comparison to just having the thought of homo sinuality.
Yeah.
Big Brother's watching you, Mario.
He knows.
He's watching Mario. Big Brother. He knows.
Big Brother's a top.
Yeah.
Before we move on to the next thing, guys, really quick, if you could just take a moment to hit the like button. Every time a bunch of you hit the like button, a bunch more people come in to watch us. This channel is old as shit, and it doesn't send out notifications to everybody when we go live. Wow. So if you could like the stream, that'd be great. Also, use the link in the description to download the Brave browser and use it to watch every single DP episode. It monetizes attention on the internet, and it's been paying off bigly.
One like equals one forgiveness for Mario's homo thoughts.
Yes, remember that. If you want to forgive Mario's homo thoughts and send him to salvation, a like is one all we need.
Simple like.
I see Ryby Jenkins in the chat.
Ryby Jenkins! Sweet.
I had the bad thoughts about the Luigi.
So we're going to get into this. This is kind of a special thing. We're going to watch a whole bunch of trailers.
Are we going to do the Repsion thing?
And if you send in any Streamlabs or anything, we'll read it after our first break that we're going to take here.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? I will get that.
Yeah.
You know what? Let me get that really quick.
What is it?
Everyone talk to them really quick while I get this.
Our friend of the show, Repsion, is he's trying to do something special with his brand. And I just want to take the time to signal boost him on Drunken Peasants and give him a little extra push to see his dreams come true. It's that simple. So while Ben finds that, let's just talk amongst ourselves. Maybe we could reflect on Mario's homosexual thoughts or something. I don't know.
It's under media, right? Yeah.
How are you guys doing?
Oh, yeah. Here it is.
How are the EFAP boys doing tonight, this week?
Oh, wonderfully. We have infinite fun to comment upon.
The fun never ends, thanks to Jesus.
To Jesus.
It's good, clean, Christian fun.
Have any of you guys seen the movie Beach Bum? I gotta say,
watching Mario cry has definitely made my week a lot happier.
I don't know if it tops the baptism video, though.
Oh, God, nothing tops that video.
Oh, my God, I love that. Where he cries in the swimming pool.
Yeah,
there's like the hairy guy just standing behind him. Oh, there's a video Mario, he's standing in this, like, this swimming pool, and there's this big hairy dude with, like, a like one of those pool noodles next to him, and he's just like watching Mario cry.
Yeah, Mario's just crying. All
right, it's like an adult baptism or whatever, right? The deal is he's getting cleansed.
Yeah, he's getting born again, basically. Right.
It's just 10 minutes of him sobbing, and it's the best thing I've ever
seen. Jesus in my eyes.
Before we get into this, movie trailer thing that I set up, I do want to watch this Repsion video. Repsion is trying to become a spokesman.
He wants an endorsement.
Yeah, for
a big business. Let's see.
Yeah, he made this requesting it.
Let's see.
Hi, Fleshlight. So.
Oh my god, this is great.
Yeah, boy.
You're a brand that I've actually used myself. I have a couple of your products.
I haven't actually used Fleshlight. Man, I haven't watched Repsion in a while. This is some.
It's a new direction. It's a new direction.
Yeah, I mean, wow, maybe I should go watch his channel again. Yeah. This is exciting. I love the vertical camera, too. It's a nice touch.
You guys make a Fleshlight that's big enough for my ginormous cock.
I keep breaking all your other ones. Tweeted out for collaborations and that you're looking for people to work with. And I'm just here to tell you today that I am available. I'm about to hit 600,000 subscribers in my age demographic.
Did you put this on YouTube?
Yeah, yeah, no, it's on Twitter, yeah.
It's Twitter, yeah.
He tweeted this at Fleshlight.
He tweeted,
this is great. All right.
Oh my god, I'm looking up Repsion now. I gotta resubscribe.
Oh yeah, his main thing now is just ripping on Onision. It's actually really great. Right, Billy?
I don't know.
Primarily, I have ages 18 through 24. My audience is primarily male. 85%.
Couldn't you email this to them or something?
Oh, no.
Or send them a DM?
My audience is male.
85% male, that's... That's actually lower than a lot of channels. A lot of channels are like 90% male.
Yeah, I'm at like 98% or something like that.
Repsion is a chick magnet.
Oh, yeah.
And they're from the UK and the USA and Australia.
You think with those numbers, you wouldn't need fleshlights.
Them's the fleshlight countries.
Age and location demographics. Again, I've used your products already myself, so... Being able to work with you guys would be a fantastic opportunity.
With the amount that Repsion masturbates, you'd think he'd be better at arm wrestling, but he's not. I've arm wrestled Repsion on three different occasions, and I beat him in a matter of seconds, like in a split second.
Maybe that just means that you jerk off way more than he does.
You know what? Maybe.
Or maybe he needs.
You went with the wrong arm.
Bow to your master.
Maybe he needs to put a weight at the end of his fleshlight. An extra 20 pounds.
I don't censor myself, and I have no shame in promoting a product that will bring people much happiness and pleasure. Aww. So, let me know. I'm following you guys. I'd love to hit you up in the DMs and see if we can work something out, because, quite frankly, you guys are awesome.
They follow you, don't they?
You guys make quality products.
What?
I want to know
if this got results.
Sponsorship. I actually already tweeted at them. I said, fleshlight. Let's do a deal. I would like to make a fleshlight instead of a pussy
out of your skin
or a mouth. I would like to have a fleshlight that has a donut orifice.
You
can fuck the donut.
All right. So, first movie trailer.
I love that smug smile. Yeah.
That is a pleased man.
Just thinking of his time later tonight.
He's thinking of all that fleshlight money.
So when I was a kid. Comic book movies were garbage. They were like, if they came out with a comic book based movie, you knew it was going to be shit.
Even Batman?
I mean, the Tim Burton Batman was probably the most well-received comic book movie.
I really liked Batman Returns.
A lot of people don't even know this. There was a Captain America film released in 1990. It had a limited theatrical release. And then it went direct to video. Yeah. Here's the trailer for it. Yes.
Oh yes.
This looks like not 90.
To be the best damn candidate out of 600 volunteers.
A secret experiment gave one man the strength of 100.
The rest of the world, he's his codename Captain America.
And the power to save millions.
The Jerrys have an experimental rocket ready to fire at a target somewhere in the United States.
Only he could defeat a superhuman madman.
Look at the Red Skull. This is fucking terrible.
Looks like his head was dipped in the Dairy Queen red ice cream cone coating.
Yeah,
he looks like a candle.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's looking weird.
Less they show better on the outfit.
Oh shit!
But the world left him trapped in an icy grave until fate released him to finish a battle started decades
Thanks,
ago.
Fate.
Yeah, he's still alive. We don't know where he is.
There's a Red Skull like in present day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who he is.
Now, this evil genius is on the verge of global
it's
domination.
It's like Captain America, you got stuck in an ice block too? Whoa, what a coincidence!
I kind of like his makeup, though.
And only Captain America can stop him.
Is that a bastardized Nazi symbol, or is that...
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, it looks clearly.
Yeah, it doesn't have the right amount of pokey things.
Yeah.
Looks like a bug. This is a very dark film. Like lumens.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hancock, Ned Beatty, Darren McGavin.
Has to go run and grab
Michael
it.
Lurie,
oh, I know Dillon, two of those actors.
Yeah,
that's Kim something.
Cunningham, Scott Paulin as the Red Skull.
There's
a and Matt Salinger as the Marvel Comics hero.
In case you couldn't tell, he's the guy who plays the Red Skull.
Captain America.
We should watch
that looks
this.
Like a movie from the early 80s.
We could watch it on one of our movie... There's a lot of ideas here.
Yeah.
Here's the trial of the Incredible Hulk.
Oh, boy.
The trial... And,
oh.
And
I'm guessing this is a Lou Ferrigno.
With the trail of Incredible Hulk.
Or is it... No, it's the trial. Yeah, it's the trial.
David Banner wanted to end the running. He wanted to live in peace.
And by the way,
not
yeah, they,
Bruce Banner.
No,
TV show was David Banner.
Yeah,
right?
And actually, I have a clip of Stan Lee explaining that I'll play after this.
Ah.
I have to stop someplace, but once again, angry.
Wow,
angry enough.
Oh my god,
that's Lou Ferrigno, right?
Yes, oh. Yes.
Oh, yeah. Kill. Maybe I belong in a cage now.
And Lou Ferrigno was deaf, and he had one of those kind of like deaf accents,
yeah,
that deaf people
which
have
is way more hulky.
Yeah, well, he had no dialogue, like at least the Hulk would talk in the comic books. I don't think Lou Ferrigno spoke once.
Did
the Hulk
always talk though, or was that something that he melded
no,
into over
the
time?
Hulk always kind of talked like a caveman.
Hulk smash.
Yeah like Frankenstein type.
Imprisoned, he will struggle to hide the fury within him, but he will not succeed.
I can't stand trial. You have no choice.
Bill Bixby. Oh, yes! Shit!
What?
Yeah! Yes!
Oh, damn.
There will be
no order in this court. Hulk objects.
Yes, that's fucking good.
Hulk would like to call witness to stand.
So here's Stan Lee explaining why they called him David instead of Bruce.
Okay.
When I found out that they were changing the name from Bruce Banner to David Banner, I asked the logical question, why are you doing that? His name is supposed to be Bruce. And some genius at the network said, oh no, Stan, Bruce makes him sound homosexual.
Oh,
but I'll tell you what.
That's amazing.
He says something here that does not age well.
Was that around the same time Bruce Jenner was
famous? This is before Bruce Jenner transitioned to Caitlyn.
Of course it's before he transitioned, but Hollywood had to have known Bruce was out there fucking...
Listen to what he says.
Okay.
It sounds gay. I said, there's Bruce Jenner, the athletic decathlon champ.
Yeah. Nope, that's not a good example.
He'd never do anything like that. I know, Bruce.
But what about
that
Bruce
really
fucking Wayne?
No.
Bruce Wayne.
Bruce would never kill anybody with his
car. I don't think I knew Bruce Willis at the time, but I mentioned like
you probably should have used Bruce Lee as an example of like a manly Bruce.
They're like, you know? Stan, we can't use Bruce because of Bruce Valanche. The goblin queer.
Who's that?
Bruce Valanche? He's the goblin queer. Google Bruce Valanche.
No thanks.
The goblin queer.
Oh, yeah, I heard you say that.
He's the goblin queer.
I heard.
He's Knob Goblin.
Okay. Here's the trailer for the 1994 Fantastic Four movie trailer. Have you seen that?
Oh, I know the movie pretty well. Who is the guy who made it?
Roger Corman produced it.
Usually,
you know, a movie's gonna be shit when it's made for TV. This was made for retaining the rights.
Right. It's even worse.
Just like the new.
I mean, it's probably better than the 2015 one.
They just cake shit on the guy's body for the thing.
I'm a turtle.
That's artsy for what it looks like.
Dr. Doom looks so generic. Look at that.
He looks like a figurine.
To be honest, Dr. Doom?
A cleric and a paladin multi-class.
Yeah.
He doesn't look as bad as the Dr. Doom from the movies that came out, 10, 15 years later, the guy from Nip Tuck that played Dr. Doom.
The Jessica Alba ones.
Yeah, the Jessica Alba ones. It doesn't look that much
His
fucking
mask
worse than
looks
that.
Looks like face paint, almost. Like, it was just like, he went to the fair and got a Dr. Doom mask painted on
his
face.
This is better than Thing's suit.
Yeah, okay.
Like, I don't know. I'm not mad at... Oh, did it have retractable claws?
Yeah, I don't know.
Holy shit.
I don't remember Dr. Doom having that.
It's like Black Panther.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Yeah, Sue Storm never turns invisible, I don't think.
Which is crazy, because that's the cheapest effect to use all effects.
She's just not in the picture.
And then Johnny Storm never turns into the Human Torch.
Well, why?
I don't know.
Doom never brings doom.
Did he say curses?
Duh. Curses!
What a terrible effect for the lettering.
Did they never know how to make trailers? Like, what the fuck?
Oh, God. She gets a full gown, but he has to wear his Fantastic Four suit. Why does she get the full gown, but the guys are all in suit? Why? Why is that marriage? Why is that a wedding? Why?
Because sexism. Because sexism.
Because she doesn't look... Like, I don't know, maybe she looks better in a gown than that silly outfit.
True. They probably couldn't rent a tuxedo.
Oh my god.
Holy shit! At any price. That's a cool character!
Did he sneeze fire?
Oh, she does turn invisible! Oh, okay. I was wrong.
No, she's still there.
I was gonna say, but she's supposed to still be there.
Yeah, she's still there. They'll still hit her.
She just phased out of existence.
Yeah, she doesn't disappear from reality.
She teleported.
Oh, that's great.
Why does the thing look like he has Down syndrome?
Oh, yeah.
What? Imagine being Stadley and seeing this trailer, and you're like, well...
It was all a mistake. So,
Stanley was... Nothing? Question mark.
Stanley was too busy trying to be in Mallrats at this time. He was breaking into Hollywood.
Surprised it didn't make him die right away. I was surprised he lived so many years after this.
Wow. Well, I had a good run.
He must have been so fucking happy with Iron Man. He must have been like, holy shit, we're getting somewhere.
You know that Incredible Hulk trailer we just watched? Stan Lee actually did a cameo in that. Mm-hmm. He was a jury member in the trial of the Incredible Hulk.
One of the movie locks up forever. These are pants.
Who is this?
What? Why is Mad-Eye Moody in this movie?
The fantastic. The best thing about this trailer, no matter how bad it looks, it makes the movie look better than it is. The movie is so bad.
The movie is so fucking terrible.
So bad.
Here's the Amazing Spider-Man 1970.
Ooh.
Uh-oh. Now we're going really far back.
Oh, yeah.
The world's favorite comic book hero. Followed by 84 million readers a year. Now, he comes alive. For the first time on the screen, you'll see it all. The spectacular adventures of the Amazing Spider-Man.
He can do the things a spider does, you know, climb walls and spin webs, and he's very, very strong.
You've heard about it.
He's very, very strong.
Very strong.
Licks the bugs up.
The Amazing Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Now, you'll see him.
Hold on his eye.
Kill him!
Oh, shit! He's on the ceiling!
No challenge is too great. No enemy is too strong. The most popular, most daring, most exciting superhero in the entire world. At last, he comes alive.
Why did he do that? Instead of hitting you, I'll let you hit me. Ah!
Do you think majority of audiences were like, whoa?
Whoa, that's amazing.
I mean, I gotta say, out of all the trailers we've seen, this is the best looking one so far.
Yeah, and it's so old. I think Captain America
looked better than this.
It's like almost 50 years old. That's crazy.
Well, the thing is, there's a 20-year gap between this and the Captain America one, and they look identical in quality.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is definitely better for its age.
Just incredible adventure.
This one probably had a way higher budget than the Captain America one. I'd be willing to guess.
Guys, why don't we just hit him with our sticks?
Wow, look at that web. That's terrible.
No, spider.
Did he step on them?
He walks over.
Roy should have started out with that one.
A madman who's turning the streets into a siege of terror. More and more people are being mysteriously hypnotized into threatening the entire city and destroying themselves. Look up high. As one man
Shaft.
Looks up high.
Spider Shaft.
He uses all his fantastic spider powers to battle the most evil
his fantastic spider
powers. Army, all the sticks they could ever use.
Here's
they're really banking on the whole wall climbing thing to be a huge draw, aren't they?
Yeah.
In 1978, they made a sequel, Spider-Man Strikes Back.
Hmm.
Strikes back.
Yeah.
What's he striking back?
Didn't he win in the first one?
Spider-Man.
And he's ready for the adventure that will be the greatest challenge to all his powers.
He kicked him in the ass.
Hell yeah.
Woo!
Woo! It'd be awesome if he used her as a flotation device and just landed on her body.
Well,
you gotta feel bad for them having such technical limitations.
Yeah.
I'm happy they tried.
Oh shit. Damn.
This is Eggman's dad's movie set.
Spider-Man strikes back.
I don't understand why he's striking back.
He's going against the Jedi.
He's
taking over for the Empire.
This was before Empire Strikes Back.
But it was after Star Wars, so Star Wars stole from Spider-Man. Is that Bobby the Brain Heenan?
No.
What can they do with an atomic bomb?
What can they do with an atomic bomb? With an atomic bomb.
Take the control.
What do you want?
We want you, Parker.
Quite a chop.
Suddenly, it's a race for survival.
Fucking trailer,
is that the same shot?
This nightmare. Only the man who can become Spider-Man.
Only the man that can become Spider-Man. What is that voice?
Yeah, what is that gag? Is that a gag supposed to be? Oh god, it's Colonel Sanders.
Yeah.
He's a well-known Spider-Man villain.
There's the Death Star.
I like the whole premise of the film is Colonel Sanders going, the only thing that should be in my house that has eight legs is a KFC bucket, Spider-Man.
I just saw this thing the other day of Glenn Beck dressed up as Colonel Sanders. He looks a lot like him.
The new Colonel Sanders is a CGI influencer.
I liked it when all the random comedians were playing Colonel Sanders. Yeah, that was cool.
They traded him in for a CGI Instagram influencer.
Fuck that.
Is that elbow
hold
drop?
Hold on. Spider-Man cannot fly. What the fuck is this?
He doesn't need to fly. He's a spider. He'll just shoot some web when he gets to a building.
He's falling with style.
He can jump from a helicopter.
Yeah, then he shoots his web at a building.
Anybody, to be fair,
him.
Anybody can jump from a helicopter. True. That's not a superpower.
True. Was that from the first
shot
movie? Yeah. Now with more bikini girls.
Oh no, Kettle.
If only we invested in guns or something.
Oh shit.
The excitement is supercharged when Spider-Man strikes back.
Lewis Hammond.
That poor man.
There was also a Doctor Strange film that was made in the 70s.
Look at Spider-Man's foot there at the end. That looked painful.
Yeah.
Did Doctor Strange film even work in the 70s?
This modern hospital may seem worlds apart from the days of ancient sorcerers. But for psychiatrist Stephen Strange and his beautiful patient, this is where those worlds collide. And the nightmare begins.
On duty.
We're here interviewing the founder of the LaFame Method, a woman who in the last few days seems to have taken at least a part of New York City by storm, so to speak. Here to tell us more about it is the force behind the LaFame Method, Morgan Le Fay. Miss Le Fay, can you tell us just what it is?
Morgan Le Fay? That's a name that they lifted from the Once and Future King.
Exactly, that the method does. Quite simply, it unlocks the hidden potential within you. It's a way of realizing your own powers and using them to get what you really want out of life.
What the fuck? Yeah. Why are people getting pushed off of bridges?
Is this like a horror movie?
She got powers.
And pushed him over a railing in front of a car.
Nothing Stephen Strange learned in medical school could prepare him for an attack by an evil sorceress from the fourth dimension. A villain who can only be stopped by an earthly master.
That's the worst dimension of them all.
Yeah. I could easily handle third, second, or first dimension, but fourth dimension.
Because you don't play 4D chess, pussy.
Yeah, I don't.
Come in.
Thank you.
I see you from the fourth dimension.
You're telling me you're a sorcerer. I came here to try to help a patient.
Is that Mr. Feeney?
Come yeah.
And take him into our domain. Now it's up to Stephen Strange to take the place
my God.
Of the
Earth's last that costume.
I'm a fucking wizard.
Yeah, look at him. This is the 1970s incarnation of Doctor Strange.
I'm not mad at it.
Are
they
you trying?
Does my mustache make you drip?
Yes, I'm the sorcerer.
You should learn whose powers to resist.
He looks way better at being Doctor Strange than Von Helton. That's
oh,
for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Come along for a fantastic adventure into the fourth
Tom
dimension.
Tom Selleck turned this role
Doctor
down.
Doctor Strange.
Now all I can do is paint. Ah.
Well,
that's an ambitious movie to try and do in the 70s.
So yeah. There must have been some success, right, for them to have done this many attempts, or were they all terrible? Like, did they all make any money, or?
You know, I haven't actually researched the box office numbers on them.
Were they? Did they go to box office, or maybe Marvel was selling made?
I mean,
for
these
TV 70s
ones, the Spider-Man one and this one were definitely theatrical releases.
Because Hulk had a good run, right? The Incredible Hulk was pretty big. So people,
yeah, I feel like there's a lot of those.
People might have
it says
optioned
that Doctor Strange got very low ratings.
Some of these were television.
As if it was going to get high ratings.
Oh, here's a great one that a lot of people don't even know existed. It's and our fans of our show know because we reviewed it recently. It's the 1998 Nick Fury Agent of the Shield.
I'm gonna run and pee real
starring
quick.
David Hasselhoff.
Oh.
From the pages of entertainment history, from a brand renowned for non-stop action adventure, from a name that stirs the imagination, from a universe where good is glowing and evil sets the screen ablaze, comes a man who will always remain a hero.
Huh? I'll get that vampire's blood if I have to suck it from her neck.
What?
He has a never-ending cigar in this movie. A cigar that never gets put out, but never gets longer or shorter. It's constantly burning at the same length.
It's like a metaphor for his eternal, vigilant, burning, just something.
Okay.
Yeah.
I agree.
Good job, Rags.
Yeah. Yeah, that was pretty fucking good job. Some deep shit.
Yeah, the CGI in this movie is pretty terrible.
Wait, when was this released?
98.
It looks real.
Oh, well, at least, you know.
Why did you just fucking kick me like that? Why are you doing this? Strange minor person?
Yesterday, Hydra stormed Trinity Base, and they killed Clay in the process.
Welcome to the Helicarrier.
Supreme Headquarters International Espionage Law Enforcement Division.
Even though you work here, we feel the need to remind you of where you work on the loudspeakers.
Yeah.
Isn't that sweet? His last words, Nick. I assume he meant his boyhood chum, Nick Fury. Well, rest assured, your friend's death is only the beginning.
There's no.
What is that accent?
Yeah, that's what I was
it's
saying.
It's supposed to be German.
It's a really dumb accent.
Where are you from, lady?
Yeah.
Well, my parents were German and my father was Hungarian, and you know, the babysitter, she was from the West Side.
They picked the lamest villains, too.
Managed to screw things up.
This is crazy.
Get him.
what?
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Did you see that? There's a scene where there's nukes
coming out of his mouth.
No, yep. there's a scene where there's nukes pointed at the Twin Towers in New York.
Oh, gee.
Oh, God, not the Twin Towers. I hope nothing ever bad happens to them.
Right, right, that's what I'm saying. This movie predicted... What was the other part? The 666 part? Yeah, when he's like, 666! Like that.
Yeah, there was some
satanic
occult.
Yeah.
David Hasselhoff is Illuminati.
Mario was too busy with hookers and blow to catch that, though.
Dumbass AC Mario. Baywatch? Oh, he's Illuminati, all right.
Manage me time tomorrow to assemble $1 billion U.S. dollars. Any attempts to back here, Manhattan?
What the fuck?
In the immediate
did they Photoshop a Hitler mustache on her?
Why is she spinning?
Why didn't they just send an email?
Yeah,
Mueller,
yeah.
We have to watch this movie.
Yeah.
I'll put it on our list.
It was one of those movies where I wanted to die watching it.
Yeah, it was bad.
$1 billion.
Yeah.
We'll almost recuperate our losses from the fucking nuclear devices that we just
buy. All right, let's take this burn a little lower.
Damn it, Fury, what do you think you're doing?
Damn it,
you're
Fury!
Mr.
Give us the coordinates, Tim.
We have a 2 cents.
Where's his cigar?
Oh yeah, he doesn't have it there when he's flying the jet.
We're gonna have two heat sinks.
Can't be distracted by the smoke.
In the movie, he had the cigar like almost the whole freaking movie.
You located the suspect correctly.
Now he's dead.
Yeah.
Sir, I have the site now.
30 minutes to the deadline. This is Hydra headquarters. Long shield in the way of New York.
Nick, thank God. I thought you were dead.
What?
I was, but then I wasn't.
Yeah.
My cigars. Perform CPR.
You must get us the abort code.
The abort code. We have to have an abortion.
Yeah.
Did they CGI the cigar out the entire...
The abort code.
Why are they spoiling the whole film?
Beat the shit out of that small woman.
For real.
Yeah, I won't play anymore. I'll let you guys watch the rest of it.
I have to know if
like, what the fuck was the point? I'm assuming we're about to see him stop the bot. It's like a trailer.
It was like a congratulatory ceremony at the end. The credits roll, and then you remember, oh yeah, that, this is a trailer.
Here's another one.
Oh?
This following preview has been approved for fucking nobody.
Across the sea of stars lies another world. A world almost exactly like ours. This is where she lives.
Because the budget needs that to be...
old,
yes. Single,
but searching. Favorite sports, windsurfing and aikido. Favorite pastimes, cigars and sex. Yeah. He has everything. Except
fulfillment.
Excuse me, what am I looking at?
I know what this is.
Breeders of the Lost Stork.
Hey, good buddy, are you home?
He has a very sudden midlife crisis. He lands.
This was based on a Marvel comic. Wasn't he in Guardians of the Galaxy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wasn't George Lucas connected to this?
Yes, yeah. He was.
The villain in this is a real bad guy.
Yeah, he actually is. He's like a convicted pedo, isn't he? Yeah, him. He was in a lot of the Tim Burton movies.
Jesus.
Yeah. To me, small visitor, I can explain
me banana.
How you got here.
Maybe you're here for some greater purpose, some cosmic cause.
Here, he's
Lorraine from Back to the Future.
Yeah.
Pushed to reassess his career goals.
That naughty hottie.
Med school?
To explore new relationships.
Howard? Howard, you perv!
To redefine
that was Tim Robbins?
It's really odd that they don't show his face like at all in his own trailer. Like that.
Well, I'm assuming it's going to be at the end of the trailer. Is it? Are they saving it?
We'll see.
But allow pets on the premises.
To adjust to.
It's weird.
Why do you have that? Why do you have that headband on? Are you a fucking kamikaze waitress?
Howard the Duck
style
is
the time.
Is like so terrible it's good kind of movie.
The changing lifestyle.
That ass though.
Until he discovers just who he really is.
Oh no.
A duck in big trouble.
Huh? Yes.
Oh no.
Some interspecies
erotica.
Yeah.
Fuck that
trapped
duck.
In a world he never made.
Yeah, they didn't even show his face.
Never made. Yeah. Like the rest of them.
He gets a cameo in Guardians of the Galaxy, doesn't he?
They didn't even show his face in the trailer. They didn't show the protagonist in the trailer.
Yep.
Probably because they didn't want people walking away from it.
And being like, that looks like shit.
Stupid duck fucking animatronic shithead.
Maybe we should make this movie, guys. Fuck it. We've got to make a movie about Howard the Duck.
Yeah, there's
don't show him in his own trailer.
There's a scene where he's looking at a Playboy, but it's an all-duck version of Playboy.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I mean, that makes sense, I guess.
Here's the 1989 Punisher movie starring Dolph Lundgren.
Oh, you know he's a genius?
Yeah, I hear he scored really high.
Yeah, Dolph Lundgren's a fucking super genius.
On the IQ test, yeah.
New World International, one of my favorites.
If society won't punish the guilty...
Evil must be punished.
He will.
Gambling's illegal in this
game. You see this board here? Every time he
miners
kills
are not allowed on the floor.
This was his first starring role after Rocky IV happened.
I put a red pin. So yeah. Far, the only thing that I've got to show for it. These little calling cards here, and a whole bunch of these.
Wilhelm scream?
Something about this Punisher.
This Punisher.
He punishes.
Yeah. That's
wait, are the knives? Are the knives his calling cards? Do you actually just forget to pick them back up? He's just like, no, I need those back.
Jump within 1,000 yards of me. He'll find out what the word punished really means.
He defends the innocent. But if you're guilty, he gives no warning.
Wow.
And shows no mercy.
What the hell is this?
Trouble.
This is actually one of the better comic book inspired films from...
Yeah, like, it looks okay.
Yeah. It's not bad. I like Dolph Lundgren well enough as an actor. Yeah, so.
And he was
did
a demand.
Did you see the John Travolta, Tom Jane Punisher movie?
Yeah.
No.
It had Kevin Nash in it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, what was that, like 2007 or something?
I think 2004.
Okay.
Yeah, so it was early 2000s.
Yeah.
Dolph Lundgren. Louis Gossett Jr.
Mr. P, happy hunting.
Mr. P.
I could have just said Punisher because of syllables, but...
Yeah, Mr. P.
A Punisher.
Mr. Well, that's because one of the reasons this looks better than the others is because during this time, you could make, like, an action movie, yeah. And that would be this movie. You just call him the Punisher, and it's a one of fill-in-the-blank action movies at the time anyway.
Especially the Punisher is one of the coolest-looking comic book anti-heroes as well. He just wears black outfits.
He doesn't have magic
guns.
Powers. He doesn't go into space. He doesn't travel between dimensions. He's not made out of
rock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He doesn't turn invisible. He just shoots people with guns. He's like, wait a second.
Yeah,
we have guns.
Are you guys familiar with the Karate Kyle meme? Have you ever seen that before? The really nerdy guy in the orange karate uniform?
I don't think so.
You
maybe if I
it
saw
if
it,
saw
I'd recognize
yeah.
it.
If you saw it, you probably would.
Yeah, it's we ended up finding out for certain, because that's a meme that's been around a long time. We ended up finding out for certain that it was actually this guy whose videos we watch and we make fun of him. Because he's a crazy guy. He's almost like Brett Keane. He's very similar to him.
Yeah.
His name's Von Helton, but he is Karate Kyle. It's so weird how that ended up. That's one of the weirdest things. I thought maybe
especially because just the name Von Helton sounds more intimidating than Karate Kyle.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And Karate Kyle.
They sound like a villain and sidekick duo.
Yep.
Von Helton and his sidekick Karate Kyle.
My name is Von Helton.
Have you guys ever seen the 1983 Superman 3 film? It was a Christopher Reeves Superman film, co-starring Richard Pryor.
Oh my god!
I think I might
this.
Have actually seen this.
I haven't seen
Gene Hackman, the one who's in The Phase 2.
Yeah,
he's in. I think all four of them. Okay. Yeah, I think Gene Hackman's in all four of them.
Who does Richard Pryor play?
Superman's black sidekick, basically.
It's time for Superman.
Superman.
Superman. Superman. Christopher Reeve and Richard Pryor.
It's just
now the evil threat is not a mere superhuman. It is a supercomputer.
Is it Brainiac?
What will it do for me?
It'll do anything you tell me to tell it to do for you.
A machine so powerful it can change the weather.
It can change the weather. The weather. Sorry, just like loading up weather.exe.
Yep.
What is your computer had?
Getting down to business.
Getting down to business.
And even reprogram Superman.
Ooh.
Yeah, yeah. They reprogram Superman.
Wow.
He's like a reporter, but he works for Vice.
I hope you don't expect me to save you, because I don't do that anymore.
Yeah.
His evil side is creating a global
Superman going his own way.
I fucking hate folks.
Yep.
No.
Oh, dude, he's gonna straighten out the Leaning Tower of Pisa.
Oh, fuck yeah, I remember
Dick
this.
Dick move.
Like, fuck you guys.
Oh, but no.
What are you doing? Hey, stop with that.
With the world.
Now it's just the Tower of Pisa. No, not dick. The Olympic torch.
He blew out the Olympic torch.
It's great.
I like how he looks directly into
it. It's just shenanigans. Nothing. What are you doing, Superman?
Only inconveniences certain aspects of our lives.
Worst enemy.
Oh, this
history as the man who killed Superman. No, but he's still our only hope for survival. I ask you to kill Superman. You're telling me you couldn't even do that.
He's the villain in Basketball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was going to say, I recognize that guy.
Yeah.
Come on, please, let's see.
All right, Webster, the game's over.
Will he conquer his evil side and conquer the super machine in time to save the world from destruction?
Probably.
Well, I guess because that's a picture of it blowing up.
Yep.
Yeah.
Superman.
So I guess
Freak.
He does all right.
I love that it shows us the whole point.
Be the best time of all.
So apparently Hackman wasn't in 3, but I know that he's in 4, which happens to be the worst.
Yeah.
Canon Films produced the last Christopher Reeve Superman movie.
Canon Films.
Yep. Superman
shot
4.
Out of his cannon.
Tells you the first two would definitely been successful, right? Like,
I think they were. Yeah.
DC should keep cast them. Should cast Hannibal Buress as Superman's sidekick in the next Superman movie. That'd be fucking dope.
This is Superman 4: The Quest for Peace.
Oh.
I don't know why it says Warner Brothers. I believe it was a Canon film.
Maybe it's released by Warner Brothers.
What the fuck
is Superman?
I'm going to do what our governments have been unwilling or unable to do. Effective immediately, I'm going to rid our planet of all nuclear weapons.
Yay.
Look at this. He throws all the nukes on Earth into the sun.
The greatest threat to Superman is Lex Luthor.
Smarter than I thought. We can make the world safe for war profits.
Oh my god.
He's created the ultimate weapon.
Nuclear Man.
Oh no.
I like a big old N on his
and Nuclear Man is voiced by Gene Hackman. So not only does Gene Hackman play Lex Luthor, but he voices Nuclear Man. Yeah, it's bad.
Why?
I don't know. It's completely pointless.
Annihilate. The Man of Steel.
You'd risk worldwide nuclear war for your own personal financial gain. Nobody wants war. I just want to keep the threat alive.
Not the Great Wall of China. Oh, it's okay. Never mind.
Thank Wait, you, what? Superman.
What just happened?
All right, I need you to build a model, but every time you put a brick in, take a picture.
Yeah. Superman is so
I'll
MAGA.
I'll explain later.
Dude of Steel. Are you gonna-
Oh my god, it's the guy from 2.5 Men. What's his name?
John Cryer?
Yeah, John Cryer.
Oh god.
Yeah, holy shit. He's like-
Wow, those chairs look very uncomfortable.
The Dude of Steel.
Oh yeah.
the Disaster.
You know you're a workaholic. Why don't you stop and smell the roses, huh?
No, I'm addicted to workaholic.
Superman 4, Christopher Reeve, Gene Hackman, Jackie Cooper, John Cryer, with
Daniel
Hemingway and Margot Kidder as Lois Lane. Superman 4.
Like, no, I can't fly.
Important adventure.
Quest for peace.
Wait, what?
Wait, he's corking a volcano.
Yeah, it's just gonna create a. It's just gonna create a giant projectile eventually.
Nah, guys, cool. I corked a volcano. We're fine.
That'll just make it so much worse in the future. Yeah.
How does he think volcanoes start?
Attack the aliens.
Superman built the wall.
By Sydney Fury.
Superman.
Yeah, there's canon. There's the canon logo right there.
Yep. Yeah. Here's another canon film.
It's pointing at the WB logo like this is them.
We're pretty far away. Space them out.
It's someone's fuck up our. Yeah.
It was released by Warner Brothers.
Yeah. Here's Masters of the Universe, which is a canon film.
Probably their best.
Yeah, maybe.
This one's pretty well done.
At the far end of the universe, there is a planet ruled by a being of utter evil.
I legit actually want to see this.
I did. I went and saw it.
I wish.
And there is only one man.
I have a delicious candy coating.
They are locked in a battle to the death. A battle that will take them across the heavens.
Stop him!
A battle that will finally be fought.
I want them to get out and brought
across the face.
This is Courtney Cox's first big role.
Yeah.
Please! Nobody move!
Oh, it's the principal from Back to the Future.
Of Earth.
But we've been moving our whole lives.
There's a lot of Star Wars-looking stuff in this movie. That, like, Skeletor's soldiers look like stormtroopers.
Darth Vader. Darth Vader, sort of.
Yeah, basically, they have a Darth Vader helmet.
I think I'm gonna need some backup.
Can you show
me?
No.
Oh, who's the guy? Who? Because he went on to do stuff too. Oh, I can't remember his name right now, but he's familiar too.
Is that Matthew Lillard?
I think so.
Oh, such a young
one. Dolph, really?
And Dolph Lundgren again.
Oh, Dolph!
Somebody help me!
This movie had almost nothing to do with He-Man besides the names of characters.
No, listen, He-Man was renowned. He's famous as being a marksman.
Yeah, yeah.
That's his thing.
Was Gwildor in this?
Dolph Lundgren, by the way. You watch Aquaman? That's where he's at right now.
he's in Aquaman?
Yeah, he's one of the king. He's like the king of one of the fucking territories.
Oh, is he the red-haired one?
He's the one that has to be convinced by the false flag thing.
What's his name? The dude with like the red hair who's like Jacqueline Glenn's dad?
Yeah, that's the one.
Okay.
Jacqueline Glenn Jacobs?
Jacqueline Glenn Jacobs.
Why is Jacqueline Glenn wearing a suit? Where the fuck is Gwildor?
Purple light.
From a distant galaxy, they have come to Earth. Dolph Lundgren as He-Man. Frank Langella as Skeletor.
Frank Langella?
Wow, Frank Langella as Skeletor?
Masters of the Universe.
Taste purple lightning, He-Man.
Hey, Wolf. You know Robot and Frank?
Oh, yeah.
That's Frank.
Actually, it's not Matthew Lillard. I don't think...
Wait.
Who is who?
Let me see.
So, the guy who plays Skeletor in that movie is the guy who plays Frank in Robot and Frank.
That's awesome.
Fuck you, He-Man!
I would like to think now that Robot and Frank is a direct sequel to this.
Probably was.
There was also a Supergirl film. It was supposed to be a Superman film for Christopher Reeve, but it was so bad he wouldn't do it. So they made it. They found a woman to play Supergirl.
Bruce Jenner takes the role over.
I'm excited.
She came halfway across the universe in search of a cosmic power force that could save her world from destruction.
Is she?
Who on earth are you?
You know, I think I recognize the costume.
From the producers of Superman.
No.
Alexander Salkind presents Superman.
Supergirl in her first great adventure.
Helen Mirren would be quite younger. You can do the whole number leap in this. It's 1984.
Yes.
Ben Steel Bars?
Ben yes. Steel Bars?
Like Superman.
He's my cousin.
Whoa.
Kissing cousins.
Supergirl, sent to Earth on a secret mission that brings her face to face with diabolical villains.
I'm considering nothing less than world domination.
Unspeakable evil.
Oh, this giant cute
kid. What?
I don't know.
You can tell that even she, while they were filming that, even she was like, this is so bad.
And super action.
Super action.
Wow, she's so evil.
What the?
What is happening?
She just couldn't fly around that?
No.
Selena, the game is finished.
Oh no. She has magic floor moving powers.
I like it. There's just so many things at once. I have no fucking clue what the hell's happening.
Satan's in this, I guess.
The Church of Satan? Now,
starring Faye Dunaway.
Now I am really upset.
Peter O'Toole.
Peter O'Toole.
My neighbors know, the criminals, the corrupt, the evil. They're here, over the hill there, with no way out.
Peter Cook.
What's in it for me?
Me.
Brenda Vaccaro.
She wants that sweet Peter Cook.
They gave her her credit, and then the scene that they showed of her was her going, ah!
Everyone else gets a line. She just gets a scream.
All right, now here's your line you're going to say.
I want to see that again. I like how they
said watching
it.
The trailer, and you see that for yourself, you're like, what the fuck, guys?
You know, after that, she shot that scene, she was like, fucking nailed it.
Brenda Vaccaro. Mark
McClure. Hi, Jimmy Olsen, photographer.
Oh! So the only actor that was in the Superman movies that was in this, too, was the guy who plays Jimmy Olsen.
Mm.
Interesting.
Jimmy Olsen getting some kisses.
And introducing Helen Slater as Supergirl.
Her career died shortly after.
Yeah. I have one last Superman-related trailer that is pretty awful, and it's the movie Steel. Does anyone remember that?
Oh, I know that one.
I don't know that one.
Okay, so when they killed off Superman in the mid-90s in the comic books...
Spoiler! Jesus.
They... A bunch of new people popped up, like new Superman-related protagonists in the story. And one of them was a guy who basically made a suit out of steel. I don't know why he was included, because the other ones were basically just like Superman. Like, there was Superboy and the Last Son of Krypton and the Cyborg Superman, and then there was Steel.
Superman's the Man of Steel, so this guy's just...
So they had Shaquille O'Neal play Steel, which is a terrible, terrible idea to have Shaquille O'Neal act.
I don't know what you mean. That's a genius idea.
Take it back. With Kazam and blue chips
it's
already
not
in the
as good
back.
As his hit video game Shaq Fu.
Yeah.
Or the Shaq Attack pinball machines.
I've already made quite a few of these dandy little toys. Do you really want to be Judd the only Nelson? Ones without my kind of firepower?
Terrorizing our cities today.
Officers down. We got a big problem here.
Now, to protect those
hey, Grandma.
Who can't fight back.
Gang's still messing with him. Up.
Worse than ever.
One man must step.
Wow, Shaq is way thinner here than he is
end
now.
Up for the people.
Well, maybe the police aren't enough. Maybe we need a new kind of firepower for ourselves.
Got you, bro.
What exactly am I supposed to be doing here?
We make our own counter weapons to take out the ones in the streets.
To stop an enemy without hurting them.
And become a new breed of hero.
might get a little
dangerous. The suit looks so bad.
I laugh at danger. Can you imagine
the idea of making... Wait, why is she on a wheelchair?
She has lasers on her wheelchair.
The laser boy?
You're around danger like a soul train dancer.
Yeah!
With a will of iron, a heart of gold,
this is fucking
and
cool.
A body of steel.
It's hammer time.
It's hammer time.
Just shoot him in the mouth.
Yeah.
What a magnetic personality.
Oh my god, you had no. Oh.
Oh, this looks great.
Getting to Shaq, such a nice guy.
Yeah.
We know. Also the magnet.
This is a beautiful film. Like,
is that Frodo? Oh no, it's not.
There's nothing wrong with this movie. I don't know why this made it into the stack of shit films.
Got style.
It's got fucking Judd Nelson and Shaquille O'Neal squaring off. Like, that's the greatest film of all time.
Fuck no.
This is the first Black Panther. This is beautiful.
The real Black Panther.
Yeah. No.
Oh no. Oh no. You down.
Shaquille O'Neal.
I'll save you, Black Bolt.
Ready, go.
The Batcave.
Man, I could be robbing.
You wanna know what you can do to help?
No, you shouldn't be robbing. That's a crime.
Don't tell Grandma.
You know what you can do to help? Don't tell Grandma.
All right. So, guys, we have more to watch, and we'll be back in just a moment after we play a quick ad. But before we do that, people were asking about the news segment. Billy and I are going to do that tonight on the post show. The post show is going to be on Twitch. So those of you who want to watch Billy and I after we're done with the normal show here, go to twitch.tv/drunkenpeasants. Go there and follow us now so that you catch all the post shows that we do there. We're going to do the news segment there. We're going to talk about Julian Assange and all that stuff on the post show on Twitch. If there was an alert sent out that it was not going to be on Twitch tonight, like if it was linked on Patreon, just disregard that. I'll delete all that stuff if that happened. I didn't even check. But yeah, we have a quick word from our sponsor tonight, which is PodCoin. Everyone, use the PodCoin app. Check it out. And it helps support the show if you listen to the show on PodCoin. We'll be right back.
Did you know that you can actually get paid just for listening to this podcast? Might sound insane, but it's true. And you can do it with the new free app called PodCoin. It literally pays you to listen to podcasts like the Drunken Peasants. Here's how it works. Listen to podcasts and earn PodCoin while you listen. Then turn that PodCoin in for gift cards at places like Amazon or Starbucks. Or, if you're a good person, you can even donate the PodCoin to charity. The more you listen, the more you earn. Download PodCoin app right now on iPhone or Android and use our code PEASANTS, that's PEASANTS, and you'll receive 300 PodCoin just for signing up. And if you listen to enough of us on there, you can get a cappuccino at Starbucks or an Amazon gift card on us. So listen to podcasts, or virtually any podcast on PodCoin, and sign up with the code PEASANTS, PEASANTS, to start earning today. It'll change the way you listen to podcasts.
All right, we're back and we're going to watch some more trailers. Thanks for waiting there, everybody. I have a very special trailer. It's not superhero related, but I wanted to play it for you guys. I don't know if you've ever seen it, so I'm just going to get it started here. Give me your opinions on this. Here it is.
You know it's going to be good with this. Oh my god. Oh.
Cheers to a fistful of Davis. What a long day wore out.
In a world where drug rape and Jesuit conspiracy run rampant, a man on a mission for the woman he loves.
My angel.
Is raped.
It's pretty great.
Director Gail Cord Schuler. With producer Gail Cord Schuler.
But she managed to ride up and down all 18 inches of my erect penis.
A Gabrielle Chana film. Steven Spielberg raves. It's the most impressive expose of Brent Spiner's rape ever made.
Was Brent Spiner ever made aware of her?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. I think Brent's...
There's a video. There's a video of these people asking him about her at some kind of convention, and he gives a really nervous answer.
Brent Spiner,
don't encourage her or something.
Yeah, she's crazy.
Brent blocked me on Twitter because I linked them both in the same tweet.
More like Brent Spineless.
Yeah, exactly. Actually, this guy that we know wanted to get one of Gail's books signed by Brent, and Brent was like, I will not do that. There's no way.
He's just a Jesuit clone, then.
Yep.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Oh, my God.
And the coup de grace.
Why?
Demonstrating?
The end of this is so great, what she says here.
No! Don't drink the Jesus juice, Macaulay Culkin! You're going to get raped! You're going to get raped!
Coming for you.
What's weird is that she's looking to the camera as if, like it's a person. Like, she's looking for reassurance.
Yeah,
There's no one there. It's just a camera propped up in her room.
Yep. You're going to get raped!
Coming fall of 2012.
And it should be Spiner's possessive.
Blood and feces. I don't think you need to worry about those everywhere.
With Gail. Wait, pause it.
Yeah.
In association with Gabrielle Chan Entertainment, a Gabrielle Chan production, a film by Gail Cord Schuler, Brent Spiner's Rape, casting by Jesus Christ, editor Brent Spiner, executive producer Gail Cord Schuler, produced by Gail Cord Schuler, screenplay by Gail Cord Schuler, directed by Gail Cord Schuler.
Why is there
Walmart?
Yeah.
Why is there a Walmart logo?
Because Gail used to work at Walmart, actually.
Of course Walmart wanted to get a piece of this.
Yeah. I like how at the end they're like, blood and feces splattered everywhere.
Coming fall of 2012. Blood and feces splatter everywhere.
Yeah.
That's so, the hook.
Yeah.
I think Gail Walmart is swearing, they're like, Gail, we've never told anyone this, but you're not qualified to be a greeter here.
I've watched the entire film. Billy and I watched it and reviewed it. It's about an hour long. It's floating around.
Is this real?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
There's an hour long film that.
It's amazing.
Yes.
She didn't make it right.
She filmed it, but it was edited and they added music and other stuff.
Is it edited by, I'm assuming, the guys who like.
Yes.
Push into her delusions and all that.
The trolls that, yeah.
Well, it was done in association with Gabrielle Chana Entertainment.
Yeah.
Gabrielle Chana
and Productions. Walmart is responsible for
that. I'm glad that Gail's still around doing things. That brings some happiness into my life.
Yeah, she's still around. We actually had Zach Knight in our Discord server not too long ago. The actual Zach Knight troll.
He was talking about getting her on the show.
Yeah. It never happened, but we could probably still work it. Did you guys know that there was a Flash, like the DC Comics, the Flash 1990 film?
I feel like I've heard of that before, yeah.
Yeah, here it is.
He just goes around showing his dick to people.
I don't know why there's
something dark and terrifying is erupting from the city's core.
I thought you were upstairs. What do you think you are doing?
Central City is crumbling.
Its people live in fear.
Here, have a green thing.
As we destroy their hero cops one by one.
Cross-reference against the sample from that gun shop they hit on Tuesday.
Barry Allen is a scientist, not a hero. But when lightning strikes...
No, scientists are heroes, dammit.
...transforms the ordinary into the extraordinary.
Heart rate is accelerating. muscle tissue expanding.
I think the Flash is kind of a boring superhero to make a movie based on. He runs fast. Cool.
Well, no, that's it's the challenge of though. What he can do with all that stuff. Yeah. Like remember Quicksilver in the recent X-Men movies?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can do a lot of creative stuff with it. It's all about the director and how their vision can come together.
And if the Flash runs backwards,
in fairness, though, the Quicksilver scenes were like a matter of minutes long, not the entire movie.
Yeah.
That's yeah, but it's
cool. He's running fast, and it's cool.
You could make a great Flash movie. It doesn't mean you're going to make a great Flash movie.
You need to make a good character out of him. You can't just have him run around.
Well, didn't they have a Flash TV series, and it was really well received?
It did very well.
I think this might be it.
It's ongoing. I'm pretty sure people hate it right now. The latest season was... I don't know.
There was also a Flash TV series in the 90s.
Yeah, that's what this is.
Is this the TV, not the movie? 200
miles per hour. I don't know. 300. I think this might be like a TV film.
I can't actually see what's happening on the screen because the quality's being weird on Skype.
Mm. Huh. Is that happening for everybody?
Right now, Billy looks terrifying on my screen.
Oh, no.
it's artifacting really bad, so I can barely see.
I'll stop sharing and then share again.
Yeah, it's been doing that on and off the whole time.
It's all good. It's not like these movies need great representation.
We have to see the Flash, Mahler. Yeah, that fixed it.
I thought the Flash went back in time by running backwards. Is that not how he goes back in time?
Crazy. I think so.
He moved his leg so fast, he actually spun through. Barry's metabolism.
The metabolism.
I can't believe it was over so quickly. Draw that anticipation with Mahler.
No way! They made a sex joke of being too quick in the bed?
Yeah, he's a two-pump chump.
That is awesome.
They told me you were the fastest man alive.
You won't get that no more.
Oh! It wasn't sex, it was the boxing match. I want you to build a hood. Cover my face so no one will know who I am. You know that insignia they all wear on their backs?
Well, I've got one of my own. Lightning bolt. Lightning?
Lightning bolt. Lightning bolt.
Not to be confused with Shazam's lightning bolt.
Oh my god.
Yeah, make a tornado, dude.
No. Whoa.
Ben, you say Flash is a bad character?
There.
Can you make tornadoes, Ben?
Isn't there a DC character called the Red Tornado that makes tornadoes?
Probably.
Yeah,
DC's characters kind of flop over on each other for a lot of the parts.
Superman can probably run as fast as the Flash, right?
Well, that's at the end of Justice League. They have that race, Superman versus the Flash.
I mean, Superman can fly faster.
But he only runs.
Well, Superman can fly.
Justice League kind of people that question,
they get fucking pissed fast because they're like, it's obviously Flash, and so we're like,
no,
super bad because you're I don't really care. I was just curious.
But they had the run at the end of Justice League where it was Superman versus the Flash. I didn't even bother to show us the outcome.
Here's a made-for-TV pilot. There used to be a popular comic series in the mid to late 90s called Generation X, and this is an advertisement for a TV pilot that they did.
What is it, like an island full of divorced people?
I wish. X-Men. Generation
X. They've got the power. Yeah. They've got the technology. They're the new generation of superheroes. Dude, this looks fucking good.
Save the world. The Jubilee.
Mankind had only recently discovered CGI.
Yeah. Get ready for Generation X
on the Fox Tuesday night movie. Dude,
I want to watch that one on one of our shit movies.
It was pretty terrible.
Made for
TV. Well, I guess
TV.
Fox lost that IP to Disney now.
Yeah. They didn't lose it. They sold the motherfucker.
Here's some scenes from the 1978 Avengers film. Captain America wore a motorcycle helmet for some reason.
The production just got Halloween costumes for these guys.
It's a
helmet has wings now.
It's a motorcycle helmet.
I want you to remember something when you get out of jail, pal. The old people around here are my friends. And if I ever hear they have problems, I'm coming after you. You got that? Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Got that, buddy?
The old
crazy
people
white
there,
people?
The old people there are actually his friends from before he was frozen. He just took care of his buds.
All Americans are my friends, regardless of their color.
Oh, he made a doo-doo gun?
Yeah, what the hell?
He made a doo-doo gun!
Was that sewage?
That was raw sewage.
He
made a poo-poo gun.
Certainly showed them.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah. For some reason, Captain America, for a while, was a motorcycle guy.
For some reason?
Watch it!
Motorcycles are cool. I had this
Why
action
is
figure.
Why shield
when I was
literally
a kid.
See-through? Like, it looks terrible.
It looks plastic.
This guy's probably thinking, "Don't worry, old lady, I'll save you from that clown man."
Isn't it supposed to like deflect bullets and shit like that?
Well, yeah.
It looks like it's made out of plastic.
It looks like
good
film.
Taste is what it does.
They probably wanted to be able to see his face when he blocked his face.
It's gonna come
just
back.
Threw it like a frisbee.
It's gonna come back, right?
Mary yep. Poppins comes back on it with her little umbrella stick.
Okay, it's going so slow.
Whatever, it's right there. Got him!
That was so bad!
You
that
dead now!
Shit. You see what I mean? Like, I know the film is old, but how did they not tell that that was awful? Like,
come
on, guys.
They had to
tossing that at him
footage.
2 feet away. How could you miss that?
Oh no! David Banner!
There's Thor!
Motherfucking
oh
Thor!
My, oh god! Jesus.
Yeah.
Whoa. Okay.
That's yep. Odin's son.
Yeah,
is that Iron Man over there?
In these films, Daredevil wears all black, too. It's really weird.
Didn't he have a black suit for a while, though?
I don't think so. Oh, yeah, I think. No, he had like a yellow. He had a red suit and a yellow suit.
Well, okay. To be in defense of the Daredevil having a black suit, do you think a blind man has any sense of style?
I mean, wait, why would black be out of style? What are you trying to say, Rex?
Shit.
Speak. You can own it, racist.
Do you feel poor now?
Whoa!
Feel the wrath of my fluffy shoulders.
Ooh!
Yeah.
This is some good stuff right here.
Thor looks so lame. It's unbelievable.
What? So it's Thor, Hulk, Captain America. Is there a fourth?
I don't think so.
We saw the guy that wasn't Captain America, or was that Captain America out of the
more
suit?
More like Justice Crowd at that point.
Yeah.
Wait, is that Iron Man?
Is that Dildo Man?
No, I don't think it's Iron Man. Here's
I'm the human dildo.
Here's what I was talking about, though. That's Daredevil right there.
Nice.
Well, he looks great next to the Incredible Hulk.
Yeah. It's
what
true.
What is incredible? The Hulk's head looks like Thor's shoulders.
They didn't know what they would do.
they were still figuring it out. We're all standing on the shoulders of giants.
They didn't want Daredevil to look too demonic.
You know,
he's like, this bite wick, who fucking knows?
Billy, we might have to make a deal with the fans to get some sort of Streamlabs going on here.
Yeah, it's bad.
Yeah. This is like the worst week we've had.
If we don't
while.
Hit that goal, we don't have a 420 show.
Yeah, dude, how can we not have a 420 damn, show?
Damn.
Shit.
Damn.
Fuck.
Do we... He looks like Twinkie Jolly Green Giant. Damn.
Yeah, dude, we have to get at least halfway there to make this better.
Give us your child.
I'm going to have to stream firstborn. At some point tomorrow, too, in order to make this work. Here's the 2003 Daredevil trailer.
That's a good movie.
No, it's
oh, right. So, yeah, no this is Daredevil terrible, but exists. It's interesting that we're 2003.
Yeah.
Oh my god, Doris Day was here.
Before it makes a sound.
You can sense it.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Everyone, let's go ballistic.
Everyone, let's go ballistic. That was hard. Well,
that was garbage.
Dude, we got Michael Clark Duncan as Kingpin was awesome. He can
vanish. I like him a lot. Kingpin, yeah.
He's there.
Then again, I just like him.
Yeah. And he's the last person. I cringed so hard when he got the fight scene at the end when Michael Clark Duncan.
That's gross. That's racist.
It's gracious.
Oh yeah, dude. He like not only do his legs get broken backwards, but then he actually falls down on them frontwards. So it's just double break.
Just thinking about it gets me. Oh.
Police suspect the vigilante Daredevil was the one to bring the criminals.
John Favreau in his first Marvel role.
Yeah, it's weird because he's the one who directs.
What if Daredevil was like? He directed Iron Man.
They ended up getting married after this movie.
Was it after?
I think so.
I don't know if it was after or during.
I'm pretty sure. And she plays Elektra, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
Elektra Nachos.
That movie did not do well. I just
wanted to get your name. Her Elektra movie
was bad. I forgot that they made that into a movie.
Oh, it was so bad.
Yeah, people like to forget about it so that Wonder Woman with Captain Marvel could take the... Man. It's the same as Blade with Black Panther. Everyone forgets about things that happened.
Forget about Steel. Find out your name.
We got Bullseye in here.
And the sad fact is that, Elektra sucked, but Blade didn't suck. Like, why can't we remember Blade?
Blade was great. Blade Trinity was kind of fucked, but the first two Blades were great. Blade Trinity was
The weird thing with Blade Trinity, they like went down like way more comedy, and it was like, what are you guys doing?
You know, Wesley Snipes owed like millions to the IRS, too, and like he moved to somewhere in Africa to escape the IRS for a while.
He went back to the motherland and couldn't save him.
Yeah. In that piece you wrote about
the kingpin. Yeah. How do you kill a man without fear? My guy.
Give me Bullseye. Oh, God. His soundtrack is cringeworthy of that film.
This Bullseye was... like this. I can't remember this actor's name. He's a great actor.
Colin Farrell?
What's his fucking name?
Colin Farrell.
Colin Farrell. Okay, yeah.
I met him. I met Colin Farrell.
You did? Was it during a Britney Spears orgy?
I worked at a hotel once and Colin Farrell checked in.
He used to date Britney Spears. Did you ask him why he took this
role? No, I didn't ask him about Daredevil.
Oh, this was a cash grab. This is like this version of Bullseye is much better than Jared Leto's version of Joker. Like they're trying to make
him a high bar.
I know, right?
I was going to say like I think I agree.
I like how nobody's commented on Kingpin yet because we're just focused on the other thing.
Marty said I love Kingpin.
We mentioned Kingpin.
I loved him.
Yeah, I don't think he was bad in Daredevil.
I'm fine honestly. With Kingpin.
He was more of like a urban Kingpin. Like when he comes out dancing, there's that scene where he's like, baby, you want me? You can get this lap dance here for free. And he's fucking, burr, 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 and he's just fucking all loked up. And you're like, I want to see a rap video with Kingpin in it.
Yeah, how can you not love his voice as well?
Yeah.
Michael Clark Duncan's like deep as fuck.
Oh yeah.
A lot of people were like, you can't just make Kingpin black. And it's like, but you can make him Michael Clark Duncan.
It doesn't matter.
Well, yeah, I'm on board.
Yeah. Clark Duncan.
Richard Pryor is Kingpin.
Look at our boy Richard Pryor is Kingpin. Look at Kingpin just throw him in the fucking roof. This fight scene, I liked this movie more than probably anybody. I don't know. It had Kevin Smith in it at the time. I was still the biggest Kevin Smith mark. I was like, oh yeah, it's Kevin Smith's gotta be good. This movie's great.
Wait, Kevin Smith was in it?
Yeah, Kevin Smith played I think the coroner or something in one of the scenes.
Ah, cool.
It was. I think this movie's worth a rewatch now when we've been so far removed because I haven't watched it since these days.
I'd watch it.
I'd watch it. I think I need to go back and watch it again. I will never watch Elektra again. That was just such shit. But I feel like this movie is worthy of another.
Wow, movie. Because it's a woman, really, Billy? Yes, because it's a woman.
I would probably go. I don't know if I would watch the Halle Berry Catwoman either. I don't know. There were some pretty.
Oh, you gotta watch that again. Laugh That's at just it. Funny.
Dude, look at her catch that shit. Look at her catch that.
I got myself some weed soda. Well,
isn't that the scene where she doesn't catch it? She gets stabbed by
Goes to her hand, right?
I think because she's a dumbass and for some reason can't even catch her own weapons.
Well, it's because Bullseye never misses.
You're probably not used to having your own weapons thrown at you, in fairness.
She fucking... Do you miss the scene where she does loads of it? She's like throwing them all over the place? Bullshit. Just because he's... And besides, why even bother trying to catch it if you're not even sure if you can?
Well, it's because she thinks she can, but Bullseye never misses, so he knows she thinks she can, so he corrected the throw to stab her in the hand.
If she'd caught it, he still wouldn't have missed. She just, you know.
Yeah, he's not throwing it at her. He's throwing it to her.
Yeah, he was just trying to pass it on, and she just let herself get stabbed. He was confused, honestly.
Yeah, he's like, save the dream.
Oh, he's just being a sweet boy, giving her weapon back.
Someone in the chat asked, about my weed soda. They said 10 milligrams. And yeah, they sell bottles here that are 100 milligrams, too, but... I don't. If I drank that whole thing, I'd be too high, and I want to enjoy an entire drink, so I just get the 10 milligrams.
I want to watch all these amazing film trailers completely lucid.
You guys gonna go see the new Hellboy coming out?
I will. I don't know. I will. I'm not excited for it, but I will.
Who's asking for that? Who wanted the Hellboy to be rebooted? I was like,
I saw the new guy that's playing Hellboy getting interviewed on TV the other day.
Yeah, he's getting David Harbour. He's getting a whole lot of
love. Thanks to Stranger Things, isn't it?
Yeah.
Do you guys remember The Phantom? The Phantom in 96.
Yes, I saw The Phantom as a kid all the time. I'd love to rewatch The Phantom.
Just take a look around. Darkness rules the earth.
In a dangerous world.
Government's trouble.
In a world.
Chaos.
Oh, I love The Phantom.
In a treacherous time.
There is opportunity in chaos.
Evil is a fact.
We shall succeed when evil is a fact.
Drax is that, a quest.
It's also an opinion.
Is that Treat Williams as the bad guy?
I don't know.
I've never heard the phrase evil is a fact.
Evil's a fact.
No, it's a lie.
Evil is some made up bullshit.
I think it's peace is a lie. I think that's what it is.
There can be no peace.
Peace.
What was that good quote earlier that was said to Mario about the lie quote?
He wanted the truth and he found it in a lie or something like that?
Yeah, that was beautiful. That one of these trailers should have used that. They went and got an Oscar.
They should use that in the next Star Wars.
Yeah.
They know far too much. And courage to stop them. You're the only one who can. Is a phantom.
Oh my god.
This summer.
His outfit is so funny.
Was Billy Zane the Phantom?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, no. Titanic.
Yeah.
There are some who say he is only a myth. Soon they will discover the Phantom is real.
The Phantom.
Everywhere.
No thanks.
You don't want to watch The Phantom? With Billy Zane?
Ooh, here's a good one.
Yeah, there we go.
Learn it well.
It's funny with all the star power in this movie, how shit it was.
Well, George Clooney,
absolutely glorious so bad. It was.
What movie is this? I'm not familiar with.
You don't know? Oh, man, you are in for a treat.
Yeah, we'll totally watch that.
I've seen clips of Batman and Robin. I've never seen the whole movie.
It's not a bad
movie. Oh, my Lord. What is that?
This is Mr. Freeze. It's Arnold Schwarzenegger as Mr. Freeze.
Who got top billing?
Are you kidding me?
What killed the dinosaurs?
You didn't know that this was a thing?
Yes,
I knew that Batman and Robin was a thing. I just never watched it.
Oh
man,
great.
It is a treat.
I'm looking forward to that.
Put it on the list.
It really is. Something else.
With ice.
Yeah, Uma Thurman as Poison Ivy.
Yes.
Yeah, it really is star-studded, this movie.
With Venom. I probably should have mentioned this.
Is it Bane in this, too?
Yeah, Bane.
Yep.
Yeah.
Poison Ivy.
Bane's played by, I think, pro wrestler Jeep Swinson.
Yeah, actually, Bane looks more like the comic book Bane in this movie than he does in the Christopher Nolan films.
He looks like a grade-A thick boy.
Only man who can stop them. I freeze.
George Clooney as Batman.
Batman with nipples.
This is what I mean. Everyone needs to see this film.
Yeah. It's alone.
Batman will watch his beloved Gotham perish.
Perish.
Left boys. Perish. Kill the heroes.
Kill the heroes.
The heroes.
Why do they want to kill the heroes?
We're killing the heroes. We didn't deserve that movie. It's bad guys.
The Bat card. The Bat credit card.
Oh God.
Yeah. Oh my God.
The hockey team from hell.
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
All right, everyone, chill.
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Chill. Julian, not the marrying kind.
I saw Arnold at a bodybuilding competition that he puts on in a city that I used to live in. And he uses his catchphrases all the time. He uses his own catchphrases.
Like the ones from this movie or just general?
Just in general. Like he was on stage talking up all the bodybuilding people there. And then he was like, don't worry, I'll be back. And then he left.
Well, it's an easy joke, right? He's on stage. I saw him after he was getting his hair cut because he got his hair cut at the studio next to the studio that I recorded the show at in L.A. or in Hollywood. And he was coming out of the haircut place, which was right next door. And I was out back.
The barbershop? Smoking.
The barbershop. Yeah, well, the haircut place.
That's what I call it.
It's a salon. It's a salon.
Oh, my God.
It's a salon. I call it a haircut place.
So, yeah, that's fair. Okay. I mean, it's not wrong.
But he was walking out, and there's like this paparazzi guy following him, hounding him for autographs. And he was sitting there talking to him, and I just was looking at him. I was like, I could kick his fucking ass. I could kick his ass.
I don't know.
I could.
Well, maybe now he's like 70.
He's not that tall. Like, I could have. Kicked his ass.
I'm sure he punches like a train still if he wanted to.
Yeah.
I mean, Arnold, when he was like 21 years old, probably could have thrown down. He was, I mean, all the roids and everything.
21-year-old Arnold could have kicked my ass.
Yeah, but Arnold is huge in Columbus, Ohio because he puts on this festival.
He's probably huge everywhere.
Well, I mean, they built a giant bronze statue in downtown Columbus.
Because he goes there
out front of the convention center because the main thing that happens there is the Arnold Classic. And he does, local commercials, the local car dealerships and shit. We'll have Arnold commercials. It's the weirdest thing ever. Arnold's like a god there.
He's a god.
A cultural icon.
Yeah, yeah, it's weird.
He never used any of his catchphrases. When I saw him.
Wild doesn't quite cover it.
Someone said Arnold should run for president. He can't. He would have... Neither of his parents were born in the U.S., and he wasn't born in the U.S., so he doesn't qualify.
As of now.
Chris O'Donnell.
I want a car. Chicks, take the car.
Oh my God.
Was Alicia Silverstone in this one?
I think she was in the previous one.
Okay.
Or was
she was Batgirl.
Yeah, Batgirl.
Alicia Silverstone.
There she is.
You are?
Batgirl.
That's not awfully PC. What about Batperson?
Found the Batcave.
Oh my God! I forgot that they say that in the movie.
Wow, this movie was woke before Black.
Yeah, back then when it was a joke.
Look at how pronounced the boy nipples are versus the girl nipples. Clooney's got solid ass nipples. Robin's got eight nipples, and her nipples are almost faded.
Still ask Joel Schumacher about the nipples.
Yeah,
why did you do that? He's like, shut up.
I get it.
Yep. Joel Schumacher film. Strength and courage.
Bane, don't give a fuck.
Partners.
The Nimmers.
Partners.
Well, if you watch this one back to back with Batman Returns, it's the most bizarre tone shift ever. These two movies, because they consider it a sequence. Batman, Batman Returns, Batman Forever, Batman and Robin. Those four movies, but the first two are not the same as the second.
Yeah, it's like watching Thor Ragnarok and then Schindler's List.
Yeah, they kind of perverted Tim Burton's vision of Batman.
Yeah. Because they kind of did it to spite him, I think.
You think so?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Well, this is the thing, right? Everyone was creeped out by Batman Returns. It's not exactly... like, I'm not surprised. That movie is fucking dark.
I love it.
At some points.
Christopher Walken's character in that.
Yeah.
How he gets all electrocuted.
So they compensated hardcore. They went, like, super campy and gay.
Danny DeVito's Penguin was gross.
Pretty good.
It was. I loved it.
Michelle Pfeiffer as Catwoman.
She was solid as Catwoman.
Yes.
But Danny DeVito's Penguin was fucking gross. He was sick. I think he had shit stains on his like onesie.
It was great. I found a relic, a trailer for an old Batman movie. This is 1943.
Never
Batman.
Before a chapter play drama so exciting, so fraught with
menace, suspense,
and breathtaking thrills.
All this Batman,
one thing to keep your mind off the Nazis.
Yep,
the Batman
or the Red Scare,
based on Bob Kane's Batman feature in Detective Comics and Batman magazines, with Luke Wilson as the Batman. The Boy Wonder, Robin.
The Boy Wonder.
Shirley Patterson has the loveliest of zombies.
What? The loveliest?
Yeah, isn't that? That's one of his best enemies. She was better than Joker at the time.
As the fiendish, traitorous Daka? What? Daka?
Daka.
She's like a that different
sounds,
universe.
Call him Daka. That sounds foreign.
By divine destiny, my country shall destroy the democratic forces of evil in the United States. To make way for the new order.
And is this the DACA, the Dreamers Act? Is this...
Yeah.
What a coincidence, he sounds a little German.
Slap his face.
Look at Batman.
Whoa!
Oh my goodness.
Slap his face. Psh,
that was like a Three Stooges slap.
Waka waka.
Thank you, I like it when you slap their faces.
Stroke his cock.
Well, look at the guy on the right.
What?
He's got like a his pants are like pulled up to his nipples. He's got like a camel toe going on.
Step back.
Put your thumb in his butthole.
Jebel.
Yes, wouldn't that be gay of him?
Battering ram excitement.
Wow, lightning gun.
Batman nips the most sinister of Nipponese plots. What's a Nipponese plot? Don't miss a single chill creme chapter.
Chill creme chapter.
Batman.
Is Batman falling to the death at the...
A Colombian serial rapist.
Well, you know what, Ben? Find out by watching it. Who knows what's going
to
happen.
So at the end of the trailer, it's Batman falling to his death.
So word is Streamlabs isn't working now. That's why we're having that problem.
Is that really it?
That's what Spec's saying. We're going to die, honky.
Dude, that just means they'll double up next time.
Dude, that
Boy!
Sucks.
Yeah.
That really, really sucks. I wonder why that's happening.
I know why.
You do?
Jesus is crying because Mario's fucking...
Let me see.
Going to rehab.
Yeah, Jesus is out of the building after that.
Streamlabs is the only streaming platform supported by the Tears of the Righteous and Jesus' purity, yeah.
Damn. Jesus died for our Streamlabs. Streamlabs died for... No good reason.
I see a few Streamlabs that came through earlier.
Earlier, yeah.
You know what? Did they play, though?
Twilight City Studios to Streamlabs has never worked for me. That sucks. Twilight's a longtime subscriber of the show. Fan of the show.
Well, I'm going to look into that, but while that's happening, I'll play... Oh, shit. Okay. Here's another Batman.
Maybe everybody should just throw us $100 right now to see if it works. Pow!
Emergency. Batman speaking. Warning all of you, brace yourselves. Big news.
Dude, you've never seen this before?
Oh, yeah.
The 1960s.
This is Batman.
A lot of people actually say that this is some of the best Batman was, like at least actor-wise. Like Adam West is oftentimes what people say is like their favorite.
I mean, it was great. For the time, it was great. And the only thing bad about this movie is that they recast Eartha Kitt with Julie Newmar because they didn't want Catwoman to be black for a movie. That was the fucked up part about this.
So they
everything
said.
Else was solid. Eartha Kitt was great.
Tell them, Robin.
Holy superlatives, Batman! It's really exciting. Soon, very soon, Batman and I will be batapulting right out of your TV sets and onto your theater streets.
That's right,
your face.
Our first full-length motion picture feature in color opens a whole new world of thrills.
Yeah.
I love this, where they're climbing the building.
Word is Adam West was a crazy man whore.
screen gives us more space on land, sea.
I'll go through and read all the Streamlabs that came through. I don't know why they wouldn't be displaying. I'll run a quick test. Adam, here, guys.
Adam West was like banging in girls air. In his suit. He was such a man.
To challenge the most bataclysmic collection of
Caesar Romero.
Their minimum objective must be.
Okay, so that's a test super chat.
That worked. I heard that.
And here are the dastardly villains. The Catwoman.
Lee Merriweather.
The Catwoman.
Was that not Julie Newmar?
It's Lee. I think there were three cat women.
Oh, fuck.
You're going to see the perfect crime when I get Batman in my claws.
The Joker. Have you heard this one? It'll kill you, Batman.
Is Joaquin Phoenix going to be better than
the
this?
Penguin.
There are two eggs.
Oh, we just got one.
Bird is going to scramble. Batman and Robin.
The Riddler.
Oh, Jesus.
Question. Whoa. Who's going to make the feathers fly and knock Batman and Robin out of the sky?
Who is it?
See, the
is
new
it you, Riddler?
The Bat Arsenal combat
do
the
we
forces
find
of
out?
Evil.
He said Bat Arse.
Super molecular dust separated? What?
So Streamlabs just work for that person, so I don't know. I don't know, guys. Someone was just able to leave another Streamlabs.
The super so molecular dust separator.
Exploding.
Oh yeah, the fucking sharks. Exploding man-eating sharks.
Oh my god.
Sardine. The relentless Megaton magnet. The unholy quartet secret submarine.
The unholy quartet. It's four.
You know,
it's four periscopes. That's pretty, why it's unholy.
I'm pretty sure the guy who played Penguin on this Batman is the guy that played Rocky's trainer in the Rocky movies.
Burgess Meredith.
Yes. Yes.
Ah.
Fire one.
Wham.
The Batboat in action.
The Batboat. The Batboat.
There's nothing particularly batty about the Batboat, Batman.
Yeah.
It's like bat rope. It's just. This is
intense. All right, so I gotta fix this.
Zap!
The deadly disintegrator.
Oh, dude.
As opposed to
the
safe disintegrator.
He's just disintegrating.
As opposed to the safe disintegrator.
Fisher Price, baby's first disintegrator.
Holy hallucination!
Man. Kicked him out of existence.
Yeah, they always play that music drop every time. Yeah,
manned missiles.
And you'll be with me, Robin, at the Bat Scanner, eavesdropping on Batman's romance. And you'll shudder.
Couldn't call it Gator.
Eavesdropping. So Robin's a voyeur. Apparently.
Yeah, he likes to watch.
Yeah.
Better than him being a catamite, like in all the other series.
Polaris missiles.
Brace yourself, Robin. This could be the end. And that's just a sample of the exciting exploits ahead in our
just
first
a
feature motion picture.
Holy memoranda, folks. Make a note not to miss it.
Good thinking, Robin.
Good thinking.
Low pause.
Good, yeah.
Good thinking,
Robin.
Adam West and William Shatner went to the same school of acting.
I think you're right about that.
Dynamic. Pause School of Acting.
I thought we'd move away from the superhero thing for a moment here.
Yeah?
Especially since we have the EFAP guys here. We can watch some George Lucas-inspired trailers. Here's one of my personal favorites.
In a galaxy far, far away, a brother and sister search for their missing parents.
I know this one.
That's what I looked like when I was a kid. The little blonde-haired thing.
And fate leads them to the magical Ewoks.
Are Ewoks magical?
Yeah.
Are they magical?
Yeah, they have like the Sunstar Shadowstone and all that shit.
I remember watching these as a kid. There is like actually a literal witch that shows up in the second movie.
Low gray and all that stuff. Yeah, there's like an animated one too. They're fucking magic. Like magic's a thing. The Force doesn't just belong to the Jedi. The Ewoks have it too.
Now, a great adventure.
I remember one dude like shoves his arm inside a tree and the tree like eats it because there's a giant worm in it.
Oh. So they're really bad movies.
Yeah.
From Lucasfilms Limited, Ewok on the Wild Side.
You hear that?
You hear that?
Presents Fire Ship.
Oh my god, no!
It's an action-packed motion
special
picture.
Special guest, Ray Harryhausen.
Was that a Rancor back there?
I don't think it was. I think it was
It was like a literal giant.
Well, the giant, yeah, but I thought before that it was a Rancor. But
literal actual
giant. There's no Rancor in the movie.
Why did you say literal giant?
Because I had to, not like, a figurative giant.
Describe it.
Well, yeah, because I swear there was an animal before the giant that was more animalistic than
There was like some giant wolf thing, and then there's like some weird dragon that like one of the Ewoks fight off.
Yeah.
Then there's like the tree worm that eats the kid's arm.
Special effects from really the award-winning team of Industrial Light and Magic.
That's Mommy and Daddy.
Oh my god.
Took away
sometimes
their
when you search for the impossible, an unbelievable adventure unfolds.
I wish
I love that the trailer shows what happens to the giant.
Right!
Yeah.
I hope they make it in the film.
Where I came from.
Don't miss The Ewok Adventure. Now on video cassette from MGM UA Home Video.
It could be great.
God, I read the old Star Wars books when I was a kid, and they actually referenced those movies.
Yep.
Really? And even as a kid, I was like, why would you ever reference those? You really should have just pretended.
But did they reference the holiday special? That's
no,
important.
I don't think anyone's ever referenced the holiday special.
The crazy thing about the Ewok Adventures is that they made two of them.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I know.
Because the
parents both die at the very beginning of the first or the second one.
Yeah. Oh.
When the whole point of the first one was to get the parents back.
Damn.
Right.
It was so stupid.
Turns out being an orphan is fun.
And they made this old dude, and there's a witch, and I don't really remember too much of the second one. But, yeah.
I watched some trippy movies.
There was animated Ewok movies?
Yeah, there were animated Ewok ones. Yeah, absolutely.
Ewoks.
There was absolutely animated ones. They were kids... animated Ewok adventures with fucking magic and shit, and they made up like these orc things that lived in the swamps and stuff, and they were like the bad guys.
All right,
Why are the orcs always the bad guys, dude?
Because they're ugly.
Hey, they're sympathetic in the really bad Warcraft movie that came out 3 years ago.
I loved Ewoks when I was a kid, though. I fell for every little bit of it.
Yeah, that was
you mentioned the Warcraft movie. When I went to Vegas, I was wearing a shirt that had the Horde symbol on it, and I was stopped randomly on the casino floor by some random guy. He's like, "Oh, dude, you like World of Warcraft?" He's like, "I mean, it's just a little bit. It's all right." And he's like, "You see that Warcraft movie? It's so fucking awesome." I'm like, "No, I haven't seen it yet." Like, "You should totally check it out, man. It's amazing."
That guy sounds great. You should go on to go watch it with him.
But no, what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
Oh. I just like the idea that he's being overly fucking enthusiastic. Then you go, "Let's go watch it right now." And he's like, "Wait, what? Oh." Okay.
From the creator of Star Wars.
This is it.
Yeah.
Little Nobbins.
Oh, no. This one.
Open the black gate.
Is awakening.
Why, I've been in some dealing with some shit on EFAP because I pissed off some people by saying that this movie sucked.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
great army. Can you?
I liked it as a kid.
As a kid, I loved it. But then I watched it again as an adult, and I'm like, this has aged really badly.
People in the chat are already getting mad just in case we talk shit about Willow.
You know why? Everyone watched it when they were super young. This is totally our generation's young movie, you know? Like, really young.
You dare speak ill of Mad Mardigan?
Fun fact about Willow is George Lucas tried to get the rights to make the Lord of the Rings movies, but... they wouldn't give it to him, so he made this pretty much just to spite the Tolkien estate, and it really shows because this is just a really bad ripoff of the Lord of the Rings.
It was a spite of cinema.
Yeah.
Didn't he always want... I'm pretty sure that his original vision for Tatooine and Luke Skywalker and his family were all a bunch of little people, right?
Really?
That wouldn't shock me. He wanted to make Han Solo a green alien.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he had said that he wanted Luke Skywalker to be a midget. Oh, that would have been awesome. I'm almost.
But then, what positive. If Leia wasn't? Would she still have been his sister? One of those. So grown...
after watching, well, yeah, after knowing about Willow, maybe it's like a fetish.
Yeah. Oh, it's kind of. I don't like to use the word fetish when it comes to dwarfs. I think it's more like a deep respect.
A deep sexual respect.
Sexual respect. Your
journey. What are you doing with that human baby, Peck?
Like, I have a deep respect for Frank.
So, one of the most annoying things about it, though, is, fucking, what's it, why have I forgotten it? Warwick Davis, the way he says his wife's name throughout the movie,
Kaya. Kaya.
It's like, please stop.
Heroes come in all sizes.
But usually they're large.
But adventure doesn't come any bigger than this.
Find the child!
I'm not afraid of you! After them!
You're gonna get a kill! Ah, yeah.
Adjust them completely.
That was the coach from Just the 10 of Us or whatever. Coach Lubbock.
The next great adventure.
You are great.
Willow.
I'm all right.
You are great. Coming and Mad Morgan takes a fucking pratfall.
I think that was right before Val Kilmer did the Doors movie, which was basically the role he was born to play.
So Ron Howard does a Lucasfilm and it's not Solo?
I would say Doc Holliday was his born to play role.
Have you seen the Doors movie?
Well, I mean, it's probably I would assume it's great and everything, but like I'm assuming you've seen Tombstone.
Pretty crazy good.
Nobody else. I mean, like he played basically the perfect Jim Morrison.
I mean, the thing he's not. He's a pretty good actor. in general, I guess.
He was what?
And then he was Batman.
He was a pretty good Batman. Was he?
Not the worst.
Wasn't a bad Batman. He was better than Clooney.
He was fine. I don't really have a, it was just kind of, I don't know, maybe it's the fact that, like, most Batmen are just, like, slightly quippy, don't say much in the fights, but then as Bruce Wayne, it's always pretty neutral. Like, I am going to this charity function. I am not a superhero. And then as Batman, they're like, I'll stop you, villain. And you're just like, you need something.
He even, like, they could have hired someone to do the singing parts. They could hire an actor to act and then hire a singer to do the singing parts, but he even did that, and he sounded
like...
an
actor to act.
I mean, he even sounded like Jim Morrison, singing like him.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's
what a lot of the guys do, right?
His best role.
Jamie Foxx played Ray Charles and did really well singing for him.
Sure, Jamie Foxx is a good singer.
Yeah. They look for somebody who can do
both. It's always really weird that Val Kilmer was Elvis in True Romance.
Yes. Yeah.
Even though his tiny role and off-screen almost. It's just such a strange thing that happened.
Have you seen THX 1138?
It's into Yuma.
It's George Lucas's first film, THX 1138.
Oh no, I haven't seen that.
Yeah, here's the trailer for it.
The future is coming.
All Earth Council, in its infinite wisdom, has decided these two numbers are to be disposed of. The Biochemical Forum has demands to make on their parts, however, before they are eliminated. That's the kind of efficiency that makes you proud to live in this era.
A love story filmed on location in the 21st century.
Wow.
You say so.
Robert Duvall.
It's a shame they didn't bring back any acting tips.
Donald Pleasance. Wow.
I don't know where he's from.
Halloween.
Yeah, yeah. Dr. Loomis.
I heard that the Drunken Peasants was named after Donald Pleasance. He was the original DP.
Okay.
Is that not true?
This series, compared to 38. Where are you, dude?
Just back off, THX 1138.
You have asked, are we happy? Are we happy and effective? Consultation with leading experts in the field makes it perfectly clear, that we are all now programmed for perfect happiness, perfect happiness.
Deliver 38, we're tricked.
Are you all right?
Are you all right?
What did they do to you?
You kiss your mother with
there a are, of course, occasional technical or electronic errors in programming and or surveillance which produce perverse exceptions.
Huh? Like homosinuality.
Yeah.
First they start skipping prescribed drug dosages, then they begin touching, then indulging in various sexual acts, and the ultimate perversion, love. For such extreme psychobiological misfunction, only isolation will do. Despite rumors to the contrary, it should be made perfectly clear, there have been no, repeat, no unprogrammed departures, no pursuits.
Oh shit!
So what do you guys think so far?
I mean, it's probably the best trailer we've watched.
Yeah. Yeah, it's
there was a tit in it, so.
Yeah.
Worth it.
It's pre-Star Wars George Lucas. It's interesting. It's very slow moving, like a lot of sci-fi was at the time.
It's like a, I don't know what to call the genre exactly, but it reminds me of like Equilibrium or
Blade Runner type of thing. Sort of dystopian sci-fi.
Yeah, societies where they're trying to reach some sort of unification.
Yeah.
Jesus.
The Shell people will attack any
car crash
venturing beyond prescribed areas.
What's happening?
The future is here. THX 1138.
Love story filmed on location in the 21st century.
I feel like that ruins it.
Like, oh, it's filmed on location.
Yeah.
Which location?
As opposed to other films, which are not filmed at any location.
American Graffiti was filmed on location.
You film peasants don't know what that means because you losers.
Before...
It's a very high-level film term, okay?
I wish I was an intellectual.
Mm-hmm.
Before we wrap up the show, I have a few more very interesting trailers to play that I'm not sure if you guys have ever seen. Some of most of our audience has seen this before, but I thought I'd share it with you guys too. We have a fan of our show that goes by the name Egghead. And,
oh, Egghead.
Yeah, and Egghead's dad and his uncle make these Western films. And I thought I'd share some of the trailers of those with you guys so you could see this. This is for one of the more recent ones. It's called Canyon Trail.
Oh, I've seen this.
Only one thin dime, yes sir, one thin dime. That's all it's going to take to see the huge man-eating plant.
If I thought you were back-talking me, I would give you another lick with my skillet.
I ain't never been on anything went this fast before.
You know, there's a path that leads down into a canyon. You can't miss it. Hardly anybody goes
down. They call
down
it
there.
Canyon Trail.
Yeah.
Saves you a whole day.
Saves you a whole day.
Well, that means a lot when you only miss 30. This was back before recoil was invented.
Yeah.
You all are trash. My ma sent help and be out.
They went on Model Mayhem and, well, I don't know if that's literally what they did, but there's, for whatever reason, all the male actors in these movies are like dudes in their 60s, and all the women actors are like women, I would say 18 to 25. It's interesting.
Just like the world should be.
Yeah.
It's hard to get already. Hell, we'll walk right in the prettiest party you ever seen.
Hold it right there.
Oh, snap.
United States Marshal Trevor Cooper, put your hands up.
Now that you point it out, I can't unsee that every
man is old.
Every man is 60.
Yeah, and look at
every
the
man is an old man.
And look at the girl here.
You know, the boss will be here tomorrow. They'll be dead soon enough.
I ain't never seen a gang.
Yeah, and all the dudes.
Oh my god.
Egghead's dad and uncle are the two on the far left there.
What's this movie called? Daddy's Happy Trail?
Like this before. Burning out branches, like I said, all over the place.
Just one dose of this marvelous elixir every morning keeps those systems so lubricated that they're afraid to sneeze. That's why for the last 150 years, the chiefs of the Kickapoo Indians have said howl instead of bug. Right on, boys, we got him!
Nice drone shot.
All right.
What have you two been up
to? Yeah, see?
What
see?
Have you two been up to?
Good
Not
Lord.
Acting classes.
Up to now.
What is what you the editing?
Word is there's going to be a big gunfight. Thought I might get up here for a good look. Well, you boys be careful.
All right.
That's a scene from the trailer.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes me want to watch.
These all made the trailer.
Well, I have to know if this guy who's watching this gunfight, I gotta see what happens.
Shot her when she was down. No! Darby, stop! Lobo!
No, I'm a woman. I'm useless without a man.
Stop! Darby, no! You come in this house.
But he just tried to stab him.
Instead of out there talking with that. Riff-riff.
Yes, ma'am.
Twang, twang, twang.
Good day, Miss Smith.
You know, I got knowledge I ain't even thunk up yet.
Yeah.
Let me get
your fingers on the end of your shotgun like that.
This is a trailer?
Yes.
No, this is the full movie. This is the movie.
Oh, I mean,
it just looks like a supercut of a bunch of random scenes with no real cohesion at all.
Some
I don't.
People like trailers that way.
What's the movie supposed to be about?
Well, this is about the Wild West. Trail.
This movie
the
has
wild,
like 20.
Wild West.
This movie has like 20 endings.
And this
too.
Is like the seventh movie in the series or something. They've yeah. made so many of these over the years.
Series?
Oh, yeah. This is like the fifth or sixth time that these guys play these characters.
Far beyond your intelligence. Yeah, that's right. Wait a minute. What do you mean by that?
Canyon oh yeah,
Trail. Wait, are they all called Canyon Trail? Or?
No, no. This one's called Curse of the Sacred Mountain.
Oh,
Curse of the Sacred Mountain.
Yeah, Egghead's in this as a little kid. I think. Oh yeah, yeah. Okay.
Oh
I,
god.
I'm just gonna play this.
You are rich.
I'm glad they let us film this restaurant.
And just how worth it says Wilson Run is great. I mean,
just what I thought.
What do you mean rest and reprieve?
Why?
Damn, there's whores everywhere.
Well, I mean the definitions of the words rest and reprieve.
Superior. She runs that parish with an iron hand.
Know where he could be?
I've looked everywhere except in that saloon.
She's impossible.
I've looked everywhere except in that saloon. That was cute.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
This was their audition tape. You don't put that in the trailer.
Right.
And the cowgirl loves you so true.
No, you want people to watch the film.
Such a
the matter, dear?
Oh, they're like, they were looking to each other whether they should clap or not and decide to
just take another drink from
me. Look, Egghead's in the chat right now. Why?
You're flat.
Yeah, because he knows his big scene is coming up here. Yeah, clean your bathtub, Egghead.
His description's been run out of two different.
I reckon that my bathtub's just in sepia tone, Benjamin.
Just like your entire life.
Here we go. This is Egghead's scene. He's a little kid.
Young scene stealer, Egghead.
Yeah, dude. He seems so disinterested.
With a porn star teacher, he seems disinterested.
Name what of a our fourth president.
What a faggot.
There he is.
he looks exactly like he does now. I just put a goatee on him and it looks exactly the same.
Yeah.
Are you sure this isn't baby Shane Dawson?
That's Eggy.
Oh my god, it's amazing.
I don't know, Miss Scott. Didn't read your
letter. I don't know, Miss Scott. Why am I alive?
And his character in here is called Speedy Adams.
Speedy Adams. No, Miss Scott. You see, I'm gonna be a cowboy like my friend Stormy.
That's his scene. Miss and Scott. By the way, just reminding everyone, this is Egghead's bathtub.
Waka, waka, waka. Is Egghead still like doing things?
Egghead's in the chat right now. Because
I don't remember
watching
him doing much of anything.
He's still in that school to this very day.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Learning his letters and Bible verses.
He's still trying to be a cowboy like his friend Speedy.
We can bring Egghead in through the voice channel.
We could.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, this is Egghead's bathtub. He says it's a work in progress.
Guys, I clean the bathtub every day. I just use the bathtub every day, and I'm so fucking dirty.
How much money would someone have to pay you to drink water out of that bathtub?
Not enough.
Not enough. There's not enough money in the world.
No, there's not enough
in
money
Wild
in the
West
world.
Wild West dollars or modern dollars?
Modern dollars.
I'd still rather
pass. I'd be like, you know, I'll offer someone else that.
I'd be like, you know, money's not everything.
I'd still rather sit in this bathtub than touch that handle on Jared Genesis's door. That's the grossest fucking thing I've ever seen.
We watched a video of Jared a couple days ago. He's like denying the Holocaust. And talking about how it what? Yeah, you haven't seen that?
We've seen like a handful of Jared's videos. Yeah, apparently there's a whole treasure trove we were unaware of.
Oh, yeah,
across like years of different channels.
Watch.
How's it going, guys? It's Xbox Jared here.
Controversial
video for you that I know I'm going to get some shit for.
Am I right, ladies?
It's okay because that's really
yeah. And
nothing beats the.
What do you call that? What is that style?
The
hairstyle.
The sad thing is that it's not his worst haircut he's ever had. He's had worse.
Oh no, I like the bird's nest. That was my favorite.
My purpose is to say things that other people don't really have the guts to say. Not it's trying like to act like some rocker. Internet badass here, yeah. But that's just what I do.
All right.
So I've been thinking about this for a while. Just what I do. The Holocaust, the Jewish Holocaust, the Nazi Holocaust. I guess
it's not to be confused with the other Holocaust.
Yes.
Proper
this
term.
This is the Jewish Holocaust.
Did it really happen? Did all those? What is it? Over 6 million Jews really die? And it's funny because
I just love the fact that he opens this up by saying. I just love the fact that he opens this up saying, you know, I've been thinking a lot about the Holocaust lately, and it's like, who?
The Jewish Holocaust.
The Jewish one, yeah. Well, yeah, of course, but why were you thinking of the Holocaust, Jared?
In between banging my stuffed
Don't
animals and playing with
Holocaust
my action figures.
All the time?
Later on, he's like, Hitler was a very patriotic guy.
I've heard all kinds of crazy numbers. I've even heard, like, up to 18 million. I've heard 6 million. I've heard all these different numbers. It's like people don't really know for sure. And that's another thing that makes me skeptical.
That's how awful it was. Like, we don't know how many people Stalin killed. This is so fucking staggeringly many.
Right.
Well, that means it didn't happen, right?
Part of the fucking tragedies that there's more than we could count.
Skeptical. But I will admit, guys, over the years, I've become somewhat of a skeptic. I've become somewhat of a doubter. Let me explain this, because I feel there's a very, very valid reason. One very important reason that this was fake. It's simply this, guys. They wanted to tear down the white man.
Yep.
Yeah.
Really? That's interesting. I have an open mind, so I'll hear your argument.
Adolf Hitler was
now
a white man.
Now you've got my attention.
He wanted to defend Europe. He wanted to defend his white people. The Illuminati, okay? The evil
How did he just pronounce that?
Illuminati.
Illuminati?
Illuminati.
It sounded like he pronounced it wrong.
Maybe.
You know, just hearing things. Maybe I'm just wishing for more autism from
power
Jared.
In the world.
He'll give you some.
They did not want this. Do they hate white people? No. Actually, it's the complete opposite. That's the funny thing, is the Illuminati is all white people. So you're going to ask yourself, well, why would they want to destroy him?
Is it like a common thing that the Illuminati don't like white people?
Maybe.
Well, he just said they are white people.
Maybe we should ask Mario.
Yeah,
I
bring it up because he's like, contrary to what people believe,
they wouldn't
the Illuminati,
like any people, right?
You know, don't hate white people. Like, I didn't know that was a thing people say about the Illuminati.
Like, here's Dan the Brown geniusness of it. I don't want to give them credit for being geniuses, but they are very smart, and they know how to. They know how to get.
Look at his bed. What is that? Like, what is it?
It's mattresses ripped up with the mattress lining on top of it.
No, I don't think it's a foam. I think we've been over this. I think it's like foam.
Yeah, so, foam
usually
pads.
It's just a table with some sheets on it, but
that's
this is back when he
say.
Used to have mattresses.
You think he owns a table?
He used to.
Slept on it.
This is assuming his parents didn't kick him out of the house after he lost his mind and spurged out on stream.
Right.
I think that's a guarantee at this point.
Yeah.
Shit done. You cannot take them lightly, guys. What they wanted to do was they wanted to have Europe full of illegal citizens. And that's happening right now. Europe is being filled to the brim.
Hitler was a prophet.
Blacks.
What year was this?
Yeah.
What year is this on this video?
You know, I'm not sure. This was re-uploaded onto like an archive channel of him, so I'm not sure. Probably
before
2017.
It was Jared Genesis. What, Wolf? Do you remember the usernames? Like, could that maybe help picture?
He's had so many channels, and he's deleted so many of them at this point. I don't know how many
was,
there are.
Yeah, he was like Punk Rock Jared for a while.
This is Punky Jared.
This one was, he said Xbox Jared at the beginning of this video.
Yeah,
something like that.
And Middle Eastern people. The reason they're doing this, guys, okay, is so that they can tear apart first world countries and turn them into third world countries, because third world countries are easier to control and dominate and enslave. Okay, they're trying to do the very same thing with America. And I'll
admit,
it took
Vigilant Christian probably did help this happen.
Probably.
He probably thought his videos were pretty good at one point, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
This definitely does sound like a more autistic version of Mario.
Yep.
Yeah, because you laugh at it, but it's like, wow, it actually does convince some people out there that it's real. That this shit, you know, like investigating an episode of Family Guy for its Illuminati. It's like, what the fuck?
Because
we're stuck all the way back at, like, why the fuck would they even do that? It's pretty, like, of all the ways they could achieve their goals, that'd be pretty stupid, but
right.
Okay.
I see that now. That's why they didn't put a wall up. That's why we're being invaded by Mexicans.
Do you think Mario had homosexual thoughts about Jared?
Ooh.
Maybe that's why he was sobbing. He was so ashamed.
He just wanted to be taken on that dirty-ass
bed.
I
look at how often Jared changes his shirt, which looks to be about once a month.
Wait, do you think he cut the shoulders off?
Maybe.
It looks kind of like it's custom, doesn't it?
Yeah, it might
definitely
be.
Doesn't look like it came like that.
I'm just wondering how often he changes his underwear, how often he, like, wipes his ass, brushes his teeth. I mean, it's way easy to change your shirt, so all that other stuff, if he's too lazy to do that, I just think...
I mean...
I don't know.
We saw a video a long time back where he showed his desk for, like, a second and a half, and on the desk were, like, used Q-tips.
Yep. Oh!
There's so much lore.
There was
in that
so much gunk and stuff
footage.
On there. It's very interesting. It's kind of dystopian.
To his right, his doorway... looks like it's smattered with coagulated shit. So he doesn't wipe his ass. He probably scratches it because it's all irritated and gross, and then goes to open his door and leaves a fucking thumbprint of disaster.
See, that's what I told them. That's what I told these two clowns, is that the reason that that spot is on the wall is because whenever he comes and goes on that door, he pulls it closed and stuff, and eventually, over time, that grime on your hands gets on the white of the wall or the door, and it leaves a mark.
But you forget the validation of the great conflagration.
Someone was trying to say it looked like an electrical fire.
Yeah, on the door handle. That's just going to be an electrical fire on the door handle.
I don't know.
No, it's not an electrical fire. No,
it's a lot more fun to think of the fact that maybe he did like accidentally light his door on fire at some point, though.
But it's a lot.
And
more
I will
realistic.
Say, I notice here on this clip, the fish tank is on the dresser.
Yeah.
Normally, it's behind him on
usually,
the right hand side.
Usually, it's on the bed.
So you wonder there might be film footage out there. There might be clips of fish in that fish tank and what happened to them.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Oh, man, the Ninja Turtle cups on the floor. That's blasphemy. Disgusting. He drinks from that.
It's also a betrayal of the law. He's supposed to take care of that.
Oh, do you think he still has the half-eaten yo-yos in the red bin?
Oh, definitely. They're a mainstay.
Yeah.
Where's and the still a mainstay like Leonardo hanging off of that middle dresser handle. Facing inwards, of course, not facing outwards.
It's Raphael, right?
Where's the Halloween pumpkin thing that's usually...
Oh, that's a good point.
It's
it must be right behind him. I wonder if he's
somewhere.
I wonder if this is before or after he found the giant stick.
Look at his one thing too. Look at his drapes. It's like a blanket that's clipped on top of the window.
You think he still has his Hot Wheels? Think his Hot Wheels are still nailed to the wall?
Oh, definitely.
Not only
maybe.
I
think I see something on the very top right there on the wall.
Not only is his sheet being used as a curtain, but it's also being used as a hammock for his fucking jizz doll stuffed toys.
Yeah, does
that is Pluto.
You'll never
Pluto
find
is a good boy.
More character in a room than this room.
He made like two videos doing room tours, and we just analyzed the hell out of them.
Really?
So much like, to learn.
Every frame is
He's done room tours,
knowledge.
Man. You got to keep up with the lore.
I saw the one.
He went in his closet, and he took pictures of like the wall.
Yeah,
he has like stuffed animals falling into the open side of his PC.
Oh God,
that is so weird.
Begs the question how it hasn't burst into flames yet.
I saw the one video of him riding his bike. It's the only time I've ever seen him outside, besides his kung fu video that he did.
Did he have training wheels?
No.
Okay, just checking.
I mean,
the front and back wheel.
It's a valid question.
He was walking around his room for his room tour, you could hear like bottles crunching under his feet, like Pepsi and water bottles that he just let lie on the floor.
Someone in your chat there says, Stubby says his room looks lived in. No, his room looks survived in.
Yeah.
There's so much evidence in this room for some real gross shit. You know it. Vanell asks, how much would it take to sleep in the bed next to him?
Off.
Would you have a sleepover with Jared?
To the left off the camera is a skeleton as well, with like weird Illuminati symbols.
Yeah, he's drawn like runes on the plastic skeleton.
You're asking the right guys to figure out exactly what's going on here. We nearly cracked it, but you know, we didn't quite get there.
I feel like we have all these puzzle pieces, but they go to different puzzles.
Yeah.
So
you can't quite put it together, but you know you're getting closer to something.
Just like different seasons of Jared Genesis, and maybe one day we'll get a reboot of the series.
Just when you think you have all the answers, Jared starts asking new questions.
Yep.
Yeah, we've always wondered if...
Like, is the Holocaust real?
Holocaust. What if it's all an act? He actually has a pristinely clean house... And this is just the room his art in. Yes.
This like, is his creative outlet.
Yeah. And then he leaves. He has, you know, he lives in a mansion.
He puts on a suit.
Yeah.
Takes off his set shirt.
He plays piano.
Yep.
He reads Shakespeare.
Yep.
Ernest Hemingway.
Dr. Seuss.
Dr. Seuss.
He definitely reads Dr. Seuss.
This is just performance art here that he's doing.
One fish, two fish. Red fish?
Blue fish.
Ah, yes.
One of Rags, do you remember, I think it was the first time we ever streamed together, we watched a video from Jared where he was asking if Charles Manson was really that bad of a guy.
Yeah. Something like that. Was Charles Manson really that bad?
Well, he called him Charlie Manson.
Sure, yeah, like they were, like they knew each other. They were on a first date. Like, most people called him Charles Manson, but, you know, we were, his friends called him Charlie.
Friends call him Charlie.
Not friends. Charlie. All right, let's be honest. Family.
That's what this cult's about. It's about family.
Charlie Manson is family.
So what I think I'm going to do here is I'm going to put up 15-minute timer. I won't put it up on the screen. In the meantime, we'll do Q&A, and I'll go ahead and read the Streamlabs, too. If you want to send in Streamlabs, that would be much appreciated. I don't know.
Immediately.
I guess I'll zap myself and do other humiliating stuff for Streamlabs.
Will you cut off your penis with the scissors?
No.
Good, because that would be.
He's not going to go that far.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'll get electrocuted.
Maybe for $100, though.
Yeah. For some smackaroos.
Gonna turn it into a three skin.
What do we got here? I hope Streamlabs starts working for people again. What do we got?
I'm not buying that 3.78 liter jug of mayonnaise off Amazon. It's not in the budget.
So, Samail 527, please Mahler and Billy say welcome to the cum zone as dramatically and cool as possible.
Why?
Yeah.
Welcome to the cum zone. That's all.
Oh, now I'm gonna feel bad if I don't do it.
Welcome to the cum zone.
Wow.
I like that one.
Whoa. Lord Perrin, yay, I got to catch the show live. Have some money, my dudes. Thank you. Dark Chocolate, $3. Dogs aren't stupid. Fuck you, Mario.
Yeah.
Because Mario said
I agree, dogs aren't stupid.
Yeah.
I'm a stupid dog.
Dogs are fucking great.
I ate my own vomit.
Like, yeah, how do you know they didn't mean to do that? Maybe
They're hungry. So,
yeah, they didn't. Now you don't have to clean it up. That's how much they love you.
Yeah.
Jeremy Sky gave us $20 through Super Chat and said, "What did I do wrong?"
Fuck you.
What? What? That's a good song.
No, it's not.
It is. Dragon in the West, $2. Frankenstein's monster was actually very well spoken in the book. Yeah,
that's true.
I did
Mary
see
Shelley's. Yeah.
Yes, the one with what was it? Robert De Niro. He played
the book.
Right. But the
Robert De Niro.
Right. I'm pretty sure he played Frankenstein in in the Mary Shelley's Frankenstein film. Let me see. Huh. Maybe I'm wrong. Let me see.
Maybe Ben.
But I think also in the novel he had yellow skin.
Wow, what are you trying to say, Rex?
Yeah, it was Robert De Niro.
He was a Chinaman.
Robert De Niro played Frankenstein's monster. I think, or does he play Frankenstein the scientist? Let me see.
Victor von Frankenstein.
No. Robert De Niro plays the monster in Mary Shelley's Frankenstein. Came out in what year? 94.
Area.
But that in that one he's more well spoken and it's more based off the book. That's why they call it Mary Shelley's Frankenstein.
Willy Wonka.
Let's see. Kobe McKinley. I guess I have a free super chat, so here you go. Thank you. I appreciate it. Egghead gave us $2. You guys wanted the high Billy puking dog clip. You got it, Ben. The video is in the Discord DM. Should I play it?
Nice.
I'll play it. Oh my god.
High Tide Hair Hairs from Austin Holly. $2 baller. Thank you. Puts us at $99. My dude.
Damn. Thank you.
Lord Magicus, did the Streamlabs didn't show up? What's up with this Streamlabs?
I'll read them. I'll read them if they didn't show up. Magicus. I don't know why.
Took Spec 5 tries to get Streamlabs to work. Everybody who's doing this meme about me being racist needs to stop, all right?
Oh my god, yeah, that one meme that they sent me, I can't even play that one.
Stop it.
Cuz someone took a clip of Billy saying Arnold Schwarzenegger and they just cut off the end of it and they play it and make it sound like he said a racial slur.
It's not funny. Said Nager?
I said Arnold Schwarzenegger. That's all I said.
I hate Nagers.
Oh my god. All right, here we go.
Hi, Billy.
But yet I like a stupid dog going to eat its vomit, I go back to it.
Yes!
Yes!
That's
that beautiful. Jesus, man.
Yeah, yeah, now we do Hi, Billy.
Hi, Billy.
Yeah.
Hi, Billy. Man.
There's a whole bunch of them. Let's see. The reason they didn't have the DD on Daredevil's red costume was because the producers thought it looked too demonic.
Yes, the letter D, often associated with satanic imagery.
Yeah. It makes sense, Rags. You're just racist. You look, understand.
The letter D actually stands for devil. You can't have that on a suit.
If you say it 3 times, it summons the devil as well.
Yeah.
So
yeah. So 2 D's is devil. One other D and you're fucked. The guy's name's already Daredevil, so you're fucked.
It could be double devil.
Someone said, rewatch the director's cut of Daredevil. It's actually pretty good. You mean the Ben Affleck one?
See, I want to check out the director's cut.
I don't know if adding more to it would make it better.
Well, it might have a better cut, right? You can't
take scenes away until it's gone.
The director's cut might have had some stuff cut that makes the movie actually more viewable. I don't know. I want to see it now. I'm going to watch it.
Derek Centris, Sup DP, have some love. Great show and guests. Just sub to the EFAP channel. By the way, thanks for using my crazy people intro. Get a hold of me if you need anything. All right, I will. It's at Derek Centris on Twitter. All right, cool. Oh, Specs says the N-word, and I'm not going to say it.
He doesn't say the actual
got
N-word.
It working. Now, come on, people. Let's meet this goal. $2. That's all you have to do. Not doing it is so earnestly.
That's the word has its own separate meaning. He's
I know. Billy the fridge hates nerds.
Oh my god! Would you guys leave me alone? All I ever wanted to do was be a sweet boy. That's all I ever wanted to do.
Wait, are they saying niggered?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that was
that's
fine.
That's like someone who's stingy is a
nigger. I know. I just don't want it to get cut up.
Clipped.
Yeah, no, it's from the Middle English niggon.
Okay.
Yeah. No, that's where it comes from. It's originally Scandinavian.
How many times or how many of you bet that Mario beat his meat to the video of Jared dancing in a thong?
Yeah.
Seen that one?
Wasn't that one of the things?
Unfortunately.
That was one of the things that Mario confessed to in this video tonight, right? He's like, I just want to expose that I masturbated to Jared Genesis in the thong.
High tide Harry's.
It's hard to resist in fairness.
Harry's.
Yeah.
Those cakes.
That's when Satan is really pushing you.
All right, so, man.
Yes?
Let me see how much time is... Okay, we got about 6 minutes left before we end this show. Just a reminder, everybody, Billy and I are going to be on Twitch, twitch.tv/drunkenpeasants for the post show tonight. We're going to do some other segments there.
Including the news.
Here's a contribution to the cause.
Thank you. Yeah, and last time we were like, hey, if everyone just starts donating $2, we can get there. And a bunch of people did $2, and it came through in the end.
Trastrophysicist did $21, so his comment was read aloud. That's
Yeah.
That's almost worth it. Just give $20 and make the comments say all the things that you're afraid to say when you're home alone.
Now we can do the Q&A more easily. So in the chat, ask your questions.
I want to have them answered immediately.
Did you find Lord Magic as a Streamlabs, or did they not go through?
I didn't see that. I'll look again, but damn. I didn't see it.
Damn. If you guys want to ask some questions to me, Ben, or the EFAB boys, you can do that right now. Someone in chat said, haha, I love when Billy pretends not to be racist. That's not a pretend. I'm really not racist.
Well, maybe you're a really good actor.
I'm a grade A sweet boy. I'm a good actor, too. That's what makes it so hard. So hard.
Sweet boy.
I'm a grade A sweet boy. Billy, why don't you buy the 3.78 liters of mayonnaise? Mama JF needs her food. I'm not going to feed her anymore. Ever since the JF blocked me on Twitter, I feel like I don't owe her her daily mayonnaise rations.
Oh, he blocked you guys? Did he block both of you?
I got blocked because of what Billy and Jeff Holiday did.
Let's be honest.
Wait, what did they do? Are we allowed to know this?
We might have pretended to be JF and his girlfriend repeatedly in a very mean-spirited way.
It's great because... Because Jeff Holiday can do his voice.
Do a sharp, Billy.
So well. I'll play the clip for you guys so you can hear it. Have you heard JF and his girlfriend? Have you heard JF's girlfriend?
Yes, I have.
You Billy, have?
Have you heard the scandal behind Nick Gears? I have not heard that scandal. What's one thing you want to do before you die, Ben?
Oh man, I've done a lot. I don't know. I definitely want to go to Asia at some point.
Asia? Like, what part? Anywhere in particular?
The Orient?
There's a few different places. Like, I've been all over Europe, but I haven't... I've never been to Asia. I have no desire to go to South America or Africa. I might go to Australia. That sounds okay. But, if the next continent I would... go to would probably be Asia.
Violet Stoolbutter asks, why is existence so painful? All right, it's because you haven't gone through the painful part yet. At some point in time, your existence will have been so painful that you reach a breaking point, and everything else afterwards is super easy. So you just got to get through this painful part.
It'll be great.
Yeah, why is 3.78 milliliters of mayonnaise only $13 on Amazon? That must be how JF keeps his girlfriend so fit for such a cheap price.
Shoves mayonnaise into her.
Yeah, he just keeps.
He's gonna block mayo. You again, Billy.
Is this different from the girlfriend that he went to court over?
Yes.
It's kind of different.
Oh,
but she's kind of similar.
I don't know about this one.
She has similar tendencies.
Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna.
I got it.
I'm going to play the video for you guys since you haven't seen it. Here, I just grabbed it. Here it is. All right, so here's the suspect.
Please
here.
Click on the blue allow button.
This was in Vancouver. There was graffiti spray painting like Richard Spencer and like Save Richard Spencer and all this stuff and stuff about JF. And it ended up being JF's girlfriend because this surveillance video got leaked. And it's definitely JF's girlfriend. May 8th, 2018.
That's a woman. Meds Peds, is that you?
Hold on.
Yeah.
You know what's weird, though? They say it looks like a man. Like, listen. They say it looks like a man.
Is it me?
Listen.
I do see curly hair. It could be me.
It looks like a male, but I have a feeling it's a female. Especially it's written in pink. And,
Hold on.
Is this Tonka Saw?
It does kind of look like Tonka Saw from this angle.
None of us know what Tonka Saw looks like.
I watched some of his wrestling.
Hold on.
It's the girl who was accusing No White Guilt of attacking her. Is this Mama JF?
Mama JF.
All right. The best part is when Jeff Holiday shows up and starts doing JF. It's great. Here it is.
Standing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure, go ahead.
That girl that did all the graffiti love letters to you, was that the girl you're currently dating, or is that some other girl?
No, see, this is the fake news. Absolutely not. No way was my love mama JF, was she involved at all in this harmful and terrible graffiti?
Okay.
That is actually pretty good.
Yeah, it's weird really because it's like a Frenchman, but at the same time, it's kind of like Colonel Sanders.
Yeah, what? It's Quebecois.
You see, it's very Creole, almost like a Cajun kind of drawl to it.
Yeah.
She is a proud Canadian woman, and obviously anybody who would spray paint, not only that I am the king of the world, which is true, of course. But also 1488, that is a low IQ maneuver, and she is very high IQ and very sexy.
JF! I did it for you, JF! I did it on the wall for you!
We talk about this. We do not talk about this online, not where we are live.
You are the Kingy of the world, JF!
Oh shit, there's a timer.
I love you! I drew the heart on the police station for you!
That's a vocal recording of her talking.
You are going to have to go back in the crate if you keep this up.
You're I wonder who blocked you guys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, plus, you know, we're picking on a girl with serious mental issues.
You're going to have to go back in the crate if you keep
Yeah, we're above that.
Yeah.
JF! I need the mayonnaise, JF!
Yeah.
Show them your dick!
Yeah.
Spray them with the mayonnaise, JF!
Yeah.
It's literally how she sounds. It's amazing.
Yeah. So I think we're going to wrap it up, and we'll be on Twitch for the post show probably in about 10 minutes or so. I wanted to thank all the guys from EFAP for showing up.
Most definitely.
Go check out.
No problemo.
Yeah, go check out their stream. Check out the stream we were on. And yeah, and anything else you guys want to mention before we finish up?
Well, yeah. Recently I've been. Been kind of thinking about the Holocaust, the Jewish one.
Oh,
I thought you were talking
about the Armenian one. The one.
No,
that
no one gives a fuck about that one.
Should we check the last couple Streamlabs? I think there might have been some that came through. Magicus says he sent something in. I don't know if he did.
I don't see it.
But I think there was a super chat as well that we didn't read that came through while we were going over the
video. So I saw the, do a shart, Billy. And then there was, hey, Wolf and Mahler, are you going to do a video on Captain Marvel?
Oh, mine's on the way. It's going to be an hour and 50 minutes, almost.
Almost as long as the
Give
movie.
It a week.
Shit, I'll just leave it to Mahler.
Give it a week. I'm going to rip that movie apart.
All right. Thanks for being on the show, guys. And, yeah, you're welcome back again anytime.
We'll try and find Jared's room tour as well. I'm interested in that. So, Lord Magicus, we're keeping an eye out for
it. Yeah, I hope it's still up. It's an adventure, man. Oh, it's yeah. Like,
I'm sure it's been archived somewhere.
So much to learn. At the end of that room tour, you feel like you've watched all the Lord of the Rings movies. You know, like you've just gone on this virtual adventure, and now you're home again, and you don't know what to do with your life. I'm changed now. I'm not the same person I used to be.
Everybody, go to Twitch. We're going to be there very soon.
All right. Good night, everybody.
Ciao. Yeah.
See you later.
In the beginning, there was nothing. And then there was the Drunken Peasants Podcast.
Drunken Peasants. Drunken Peasants. Drunken Peasants. Drunken Peasants.
From the strangest corners of the internet, gonna get TP'd by Billy and Ben. You know where you can find them at. Get ready, cause they're gonna kick your...
Drunken Peasants. Drunken Peasants. Drunken Peasants. Drunken Peasants.